You're listening to the EYT Media Network.
And good evening and welcome to Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. It is the Carly Tire High School Football Game of the Week. It's Kane here at Central Clarion. And we're in the Carly Tire pregame show. Mike Kalinowski along with the Governor Bob Dunkel. And tonight, Bob, Kane comes in with an overall record of 3-2, Central Clarion at 0-4. And so Central Clarion looking for that first win of the season and see if they can come up with one here tonight against the Kane Wolves.
Well, you know, Mike, obviously every ball game you come out, you want to focus, you want to try and get a win. And it's very important here for Central Clarion. I think psychologically they need to get one in the win column. I think a lot of the players right now are feeling a little bit of pressure on. They want to get that first one. Sometimes the first one is the most difficult win to get.
All right, we got a lot coming your way here in the Carly Tire pregame show. We'll go inside the game. Brought to you by All Seasons Temporaries. We'll do the River Hill Automotive around D9. Field conditions, weather too, Governor's Keys, it's all on the way. And we're in the Carly Tire pregame show, part of Carly Tire High School Football. It is Kane here at Clarion area, or excuse me, Central Clarion. I'm going to say that forever. Central Clarion, well, the Wildcats.
And well, partner, in defense of you, old habits are hard to break.
They are. And that'll be coming up, and we'll take a time out. You're listening to it all right here on Explore Clarion and D9Sports.com.
He's on the 30, he's on the 20, he's on the 10, it's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools. Clarion County Community Bank. A better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
Zockrell Motor Truck Sales in Clarion is an International Diamond Edge Certified Service Department. As one of only 276 such shops in all of North America, you can be sure that when your medium or heavy-duty truck needs service, the job will be done correctly at Zockrell Motors. Our work is guaranteed nationwide at any international truck dealer, and our parts and service prices can't be beaten. Our technicians are factory-trained and factory-certified. Don't trust a shop that just thinks that they can make repairs. Come to Zockrell Motors Diamond Edge Certified Service Department. If it's maintenance you need, click ZockrellMotors.com or call us for a quote on those jobs, too. Our prices are great. Best of all, you know the repair is done right, and it's guaranteed. Get your truck service work done at Zockrell Motor Truck Sales, 2 miles north of exit 64, Interstate 80 in Clarion. Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
Dubrook, a proud member of the M&B Group, is the right choice for your next concrete project. Specializing in decorative concrete products, precast concrete products, gravel and stone delivery, Dubrook has what you need to complete your residential or commercial project. With locations in Clarion, Dubois, St. Mary's, Butler, and Evans City, Dubrook is ready to offer their professional help as your ready-mix supplier. Call 1-844-DUBROOK today.
You're listening to the EYT Media Network.
All right, back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium, it's Carly Tire High School Football Game of the Week. It's Kane here against Central Clarion County. The Wildcats and the Wolves getting set to do battle tonight, and we're going to go inside the Carly Tire pregame show as we look at the all-season temporaries inside the game. And, Bob, you look at this one. Two teams, Clarion, Central Clarion, looking to get that first win. Kane at 3-2. Kane really likes to run the ball. Their quarterback is pretty adept. He's on his way, they say, to 1,000 yards with 503 passing on the season so far. But he is one of their top running backs, along with Ricky Zampagna. Those guys really putting it together here for Kane.
Well, Mike, you're exactly right. This is an offense that does prefer to run. They will throw on you, but they want to be in that ratio of at least double the amount of runs compared to the passes. You know, certainly the less they pass, the better it's going to be from an offensive standpoint, because one, it's going to show that they are controlling the clock. Two, it's showing that they're effective. You know, they get into a ball game where they're throwing 20 or more times, they're not comfortable, because they're really not built for that. They're a team that, again, prides itself on strong offensive line play and taking control of that line of scrimmage really on both sides of the football.
And for Central Clarion, when you look at them, of course, last week a tough one over at, up at St. Mary's. They were right there neck and neck right toward the end. They dropped that one. But they are being led by senior running back Brecken Retz with 89 yards last week. Christian Simcoe picking up four touchdowns last week for 4 passes for 95 yards and 2 touchdowns. And Jace Ferguson, really, tell you what, for a young kid, we saw him against Brookville. He's got a pretty good gun on him.
Well, I think, you know, one of the big keys is you want to grow each and every week, and I think certainly we've seen that take place. And that's one of the things you have to build upon, of course. Your offensive line needs to get better. Your skill players need to get better. The speed of the game, look, whenever you're that young, I think you see it, but you don't really appreciate it until you're involved in it. And once you see that and start to become accustomed to it, I think, you know, that's a big part of the battle, big part of the equation. I think, you know, certainly as the season's unfolded, the coaching staff has watched him grow. They're pleased. They're excited about that. And they want to see continued growth. You know, part of it, Mike, you're an educator. You know this. Day one in school, your students are not going to perform like they will, you know, at the end of the first 9 weeks. Or at least they better not, or you should be unemployed. But that's another story. But
they're supposed to get better.
but you know, you're seeing the same thing. And sometimes I think, too, the fans forget, you know, these are young student-athletes, and I emphasize the student part first. But, you know, again, the situation that the team is looking for their first win, and they're really coming out focused and hope that some good things happen to them tonight.
Well, we got the dance team down there. Why don't we take a look at the dance team? They always do a fantastic job, so we'll bring them to you. They're moving there without some of the music, but give them credit. Look at them go. They don't need the music. They got Bob Dunkel up here going.
Definitely have the routine done, no question about it.
You know, give them, you know, and that's all that time and practice they put in. You know, that's why we'd like to show all the different aspects of the night. We're going to take a time out here as we'll come back. We'll go around District 9. We'll take a look at the weather, field conditions. Governor's Keys are all coming up. And it's Kane here at Central Clarion. We're at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. Carly Tire High School Football is on Explore Clarion at D9Sports.com.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins Road in Clarion. Call us toll-free at 1-800-262-2118.
Hey, Julie, nice deck. Did you get that at Tio Nesta Builder Supply?
It's Tio Nesta Builder Supply, and yes, Dave, I did.
Wonder if they sell siding and roofing at Tio Nesta Builder Supply.
It's Tio Nesta, and yes, Tio Nesta Builder Supply has that too. Come on, Dave. You've never been there? They have two showrooms for anything home improvement. Mom got a custom kitchen there. Bill down the street got the materials for his garage. They have this awesome website, www.tionestabuilders.us. You can buy online. They really have everything for the home.
Wow! I'm heading over to Tio Nesta. I know. Tio Nesta Builders.
Tio Nesta Builder Supply Home Improvement Center, family owned and operated since 1958, with locations in Tio Nesta and Shippenville.
That sounds good. I'll check them out online at tionestabuilders.us.
This is the EYT Media Network.
All right, back here at Clarion's Memorial Stadium. Mike Kalinowski, Governor Bob Dunkel, Tyler Oakes here, along Dustin Kiefer, too. As we get set for tonight, Clarion Band is down there getting set, performing here. Before the game, we'll have their halftime show coming up as well. And we're going to go into the weather conditions brought to you by J&J Feeds and Needs and Trailer Sales tonight. Clear to partly cloudy conditions. And the lows will get down to about 41. Temps will be in the 50s throughout most of the game. Just a beautiful, absolutely gorgeous night here for football. Gorgeous night for football. I wish it was like maybe 30s.
No, you're wrong. It's it is seasonal, but I would like to see it personally, from a selfish standpoint, about 10 degrees warmer.
Yeah. So field conditions brought to you by Cousin Basil. Bob, what do you think? It's artificial turf, so it's perfect.
Pretty much has to be. I was going to say, you're waiting for me to offer something insightful the paint is still showing up.
Yep.
And it's effective. It's not going to bother anyway. No one's going to trip over painted lines. Is that what you're saying?
Well, I don't know. A few of them, though, have a little slant to them. But other than that, that's pretty good.
And that is why they officially measure. You can't necessarily go by your eye.
Again, field conditions brought to you by Cousin Basil. And going around District 9 tonight, games that you can get caught up on scores on D9Sports.com all night long. Kerwinsville is at Bellwood Andis, Brockway's at Otto Eldred, Red Bank Valley's at Smithport, Cameron County is at Elk County Catholic, Bucktel at Cowdersport, Port Allegheny is at Union, AC Valley, Montauk's at Brookville, how about St. Mary's at Carn City, Dubois at Bradford, Punxsie's at Ridgeway, and Punxsie's going to get win number one. Just a prediction.
That's a bold statement out of you.
Clearfield will be at Phillipsburg Osceola, so those are the games that you'll be able to get caught up on D9Sports.com. And we're going to take one more timeout. We're going to come back. We'll have the governor's keys to the game. That'll all be coming up here in just a few moments. And it is Kane here against Central Clarion. It's the Carly Tire pregame show, part of Carly Tire High School Football, and Explore Clarion, D9Sports.com.
Locally owned and operated.
We're here, making it safer to save today. As we all adjust to the new normal, shopping for furniture is a little different. That's why our team wears masks and goes the extra mile while delivering in your home. It's why our website is so informative, enabling you to buy online or by phone. That's why we limit shoppers and offer special hours for our at-risk neighbors, first responders, and healthcare professionals. Your waiting is over. Let us help you save safely today.
Our community needs its local businesses. Let's put unity back into the community. Let's all unite to support local business. Butler Health System, proudly standing with our local businesses. Your choice matters. When the time comes, choose local. Let's all unite to support them and the other local businesses in your community. It's important because when local businesses thrive, communities thrive.
Red Bank Chevrolet, the area's number one Chevrolet dealer and Clarion County's truck headquarters. So if you're in the market for a new or used Chevrolet car, truck, or SUV, go to Red Bank Chevrolet, 500 Broad Street in New Bethlehem, or online redbankchevrolet.com. Skilled staff at Red Bank Chevrolet is ready to meet all of your automotive needs. If we don't see you today, we'll see you at Red Bank Chevrolet.
J&J Trailers and Equipment Sales on Route 66 in Shippenville is your one-stop trailer shop for all things trailers. J&J stocks over 70 trailers at a time of all shapes and sizes, including enclosed cargoes, equipment haulers, utility trailers, tilt trailers, and dump trailers. Reputable brands include CarMate, Sport Haven, PJ, Liberty, and Wells Cargo. If you are looking for the most dependable trailers on the market, backed by the industry's best warranty, choose J&J Trailers and Equipment Sales. Trailers that work for a living.
Whether it's your ATV, your camper,
plenty of room, keep it coming,
your boat,
keep dumping water, me boy,
or whatever your big kid toy may be, make sure you protect it. Carrier Insurance Agency will help establish a policy to protect your ATV, camper, boat, motorcycle, or any auto insurance coverage you may need. Receive your free quote at Carrier Insurance Agency in front of Tractor Supply in Clarion or carrierinsurancecares.com.
Hi, my name is Jason, and welcome to Sweet Basil. Come on in.
One of the biggest risks to your future could be running out of money during a longer-than-expected retirement. Many people have not yet taken the time to determine if they will have enough assets to last throughout retirement. Our Retirement Income Evaluator can help you develop a roadmap and actionable recommendations. To learn more, stop by our office located at 162 South 2nd Avenue in Clarion. Give us a call at 2223-9990 or visit JennyClarion.com. Jenny Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
You're listening to the EYT Media Network.
Right back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. We'll get that out. Oh, let's see here. We're in the Carly Tire pregame show. Bob smiling, Dustin smiling. We're just a big family up here, rocking and rolling on a Friday night. And it's time here coming up. We'll have the governor's keys on the way. We do want to let you know, too, coming up tonight here we'll have for you, of course, the national anthem as always. And we're going to have a special presentation tonight for a Bobcat line coach, longtime Bobcat line coach and teacher, Alex Arth. That'll be coming up. Dave Constantino will have that special presentation. So, well, really, you know, in his memory, well-deserved, about 37 years involved with Clarion area, with teaching and coaching and all of those things, and the different coaches that he was able to work under. You know, he had a pretty impressive resume.
Yeah, no question about certainly a very valuable member, not just of the athletic programs here that took place at Clarion, Mike, but his contribution certainly as an instructor.
We'd also like to welcome tonight the Clarion Limestone so cheerleaders. We have, they're just getting all of the festivities down there done, and Bob, and I see, you know what? Dave Constantino said he was going to make it happen. Guess what? The scoreboard's off.
You know, we talked briefly prior to the start of this one. You know, we haven't had the Constantino effect. Well, we have.
There you go.
Wait. That's Hall of Famer. Dave Constantino.
That's right. He's part of the Punxsie Chucks Hall of Fame. Well, Bob, why don't we do some of those keys to the game? We'll at least get one side in, and those are brought to you by Kale's Kitchen. Why don't we take a look at Kane first, and what do you think they need to do to win here tonight?
Well, we always start out talking about the visitors. That trend will continue tonight. I think for Kane, it is very important to start strong, establish the run. You also want to avoid turnovers. You got to figure a way to shut down this Wildcat running attack. And if you do so, then come up with an answer on how to pressure Ferguson. Because if you give him time, he's going to have success. So you got to pressure him. And finally, and this is kind of a little caveat that really comes into play with each and every ball game. Don't look past this game. Certainly, if you're Kane, you're 3-2, but you don't want to overlook this 0-4 Bobcat team or Wildcat team. See, you rubbed off of me tonight.
I know.
So for the Wildcats, Mike, I think it's important to have balance. I think you're going to have to throw and run effectively. One will complement and set up the other. The big key is you have to have success at both of them. You also must have success in first down. I talk about it all the time, constantly. Get in second manageable, third manageable, because third and 10, second and 9, it makes it very difficult for the offensive coordinator, but it makes it difficult for the offense to execute in those situations. And you have to limit your mistakes, you know, fumbles, turnovers, mental mistakes. You have to be in position to make plays. And finally, going to make some big plays defensively. I think the defense, that's going to be the key. That will help you. That'll be a real shot in the arm if your defense can come up with some big plays. And finally, of course, you have to avoid the slow start. I think it is imperative for you to get off, have success on your first or second series. Certainly you want to have success on each series, but it's critical, I think, just from a
Chrisity's Memorial Stadium, just an absolutely gorgeous night falling over Clarion here this evening. And actually, speaking of Dave Constantino, that's the voice you hear back there, the Hall of Famer himself. He's the PA announcer here tonight. So we'll hear from him as we go on. Go over, it's $5 to get in, $3 for students. Dustin Kiefer will be signing autographs that night as well. So he'll have a table set up. He does take credit cards, so he does have that machine working. So should be pretty good.
So with the up-and-coming Autumn Leaf festivities, Mike, just how much money will you spend uptown on food this week?
Probably zero.
I find that hard to believe. A hearty eater.
Everybody I know, I know so many people. I'm always busy during the week, and by the time I get home, it's like.
Well, it's tough, too, when you go out. A guy like yourself has to fight the crowd, autographs.
True. It is true.
And, where do you draw the line and say no? And guys like Dustin and I, we just blend in. We're faces in the crowd.
Well, a couple years ago. So we have the alma mater for Clarion High School. Why don't we go down and we'll listen to the alma mater for Clarion, then the anthem.
Hey folks, we have a special announcement here. On April 19th, 2021, our community lost one of the great ones, Alex Joseph Arth Jr. He was an amazing man who touched thousands of lives and thousands of students throughout his time here in Clarion. He had a giving nature that carried over to his work, where he taught at Clarion High School for roughly 37 years. Where he served as a line coach for 35 years under head coaches Norms Wald, Dave Red Bevavino, John Reich, and Larry Weiser. He also served as track coach and even dabbled a little bit into basketball. He was also that guy running the clock in virtually every game, match, or event that took place in the high school gymnasium. Long after he retired from coaching, you could see him here at the stadium, along with his wife, Mary Kay, good friend and fellow Clarionary teacher, Joe Beekner, decked out in Bobcat orange and black, on the left side aisle seats, heading up to the press box to cheer on his beloved Bobcats, and later the Wildcats. You would see the trio at various other Bobcat sporting events throughout the years, always decked out in Bobcat colors. He is survived by his wife, Mary Kay, his sons, Brian and Doug, sisters Judy and Linda, and his grandchildren, Kensington, Colin, Praiseland. At this time, we would like you to stand, and we'd like to take a moment of silence for this incredible, incredible father, husband, coach, teacher, and human being. Thank you. Thank you. We would also recognize tonight that his wife Mary Kay and his son Doug are in attendance. They are seated at the 40-yard line, at the 40-yard line closest to the scoreboard. If you could take the time just to kind of wave here and give these two individuals a rousing round of applause. And now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time we ask that you stand. Gentlemen, please remove your hats as we honor America with the playing of the Star Spangled Banner under the direction of Miss Sarah Dawson.
There you go, national anthem here at Clarion, Central Clarion, taking on Kane tonight here in the Carly Tire pregame show, getting set to wrap up that pregame show here momentarily. And we're just about a couple minutes away from the start of this one. A very nice pregame ceremony there with Dave Constantino doing the PA announcing. Central Clarion comes in at 0-4, and for Kane, they're 3-2. Got the Bob's favorite part of the game, the ceremonial coin toss coming up, and you know he's a guy about tradition. He loves tradition. I'll turn you on.
In this case, I think this part of the tradition should be thrown out the window. This is going to be 3 minutes to 4 minutes out of my life that I'm never going to get back. It's all predetermined. Everybody knows the coin toss has already taken place. This is just for show. We always talk about speeding up athletic events, and this would be a great avenue. You know, look, let's face it, the crowd's not going to argue, really.
Yep.
Whatever happens, happens. You can actually send the message up to the box of who really won the toss, and let's get it underway.
Well, here we go. The teams are down there. We're going to get the announcement here momentarily. They do all the niceties. Now, when you played, the officials would say, you. There's no swearing. None.
Well, we knew better than to swear anyways because the coaching staff I had, we would have been running for
they'd
quite some time.
We
would have been sitting on the bench the remainder of the game. On the bus, we probably wouldn't have been allowed to talk. All that good stuff coming home.
Well, Dustin's got a bet. He thinks that Kane will get the toss. Tyler said Central Clarion. We'll see. The loser has to tear everything down tonight. So here we go. You can tell we have a good time doing this.
Well, we have to, as long as we've done it.
Yeah, if not. Well, here we go. It will be Kane winning the toss. Kane's going to take it to start. That's not a Bob Dunkel choice either.
Now, you know, sometimes you get a feeling as a coach you want to start out. The percentages typically say that you don't experience a ton of success by taking the football. But, again, that's why you go ahead and play it, because sometimes as a coach you feel the percentages are on your side. I always subscribe to that theory, you know, get your guys out there, let them hit off of each other, let them get the jitters out. You know, the offense typically is about timing. Sometimes you'll do it because you figure you have a matchup. Sometimes it's weather-related. Well, obviously tonight it can't be weather-related because there is zero wind.
Yep.
It is a comfortable night. The field is not muddy, not soaked up. You know, it's one of these deals with the artificial surface. Mike, you talked about earlier, it's a perfect field right now. You could not ask for any better surface to be playing on.
Back deep here, we have Shane Ackley in the middle deep. And who's on the other side there? I think that's number one down there, Sam West. Some of the deep men for Clarion. Central Clarion getting set to kick things off is Franchino.
Yeah, kind of a little triangle set up back deep on the return.
Back deep for the Kane Wolves. Number one, Sam West. Number 22, Shane Ackley.
One of these simply gorgeous sky, Mike, as you look across the hills here in Clarion.
Yep. Those colors will be changing, too, over the coming weeks here pretty quickly. Franchino is ready. Hands up, and here we go from Clarion Area High School. Ball's going to bounce, going to be picked up by West at about the 17. Drop the football. That ball's loose. There's a big scrum for it. Who's going to have it? Clarion Area says they have it. It went off of West. And Central Clarion comes up with a huge play to start this one.
Yeah, big special teams play. Outstanding effort there. You know, just a little tough to handle, get a handle on that football, Mike. And, you know, Clarion taking advantage of an outstanding field position. Ball should be placed at the 25-yard line.
Ferguson will come ready. He's going to go with an empty backfield to start. Trips off to the left side. Single receiver on the right.
Well, Mike, if you're a Wildcat fan, you could not script a better start. You not only get to receive the kickoff in the second half, but you are taking over at the 25-yard line.
Here comes Clarion. Great field position. They're going to send Hummel in motion. Going to hand that football off, and Rhett's Rex, he's going to get wrapped up and stopped. Right there at the 25-yard line. No gain on the play that time for Clarion Area. Or Central Clarion.
Don't worry. We're both going to do it 100 times. You're exempt. I might give you the old fisheye here every now and again. But
that's usual. Ferguson, the quarterback. Braylon Beckwith will be in the backfield with him. Ferguson will come under center. Trips off to that left side. They stack the wideouts. They're going to hand that to Hummel over the left side. There goes Hummel. Here's Hummel inside the 20 and gets down to about the 15-yard line. That's on that jet sweep from the right side. He'll take it for 10 yards, and he is in the Allegheny Grill red zone. The Dewbrook red zone. Allegheny Grill with our first down. First quarter sponsor is Clarion Forest V&A.
Yeah, I think actually Hummel was surprised that there was not contact until about 8.5-9 yards down the field. Good job of sealing that lane by the offensive line.
Ferguson under center. Sends the man in motion. He's going to hand this one off to Rex over the right side. And Rex will get upended, and he'll pick up about one is all down near the 14-yard line. So second down and 9.
Brought down by Harley Morris.
Yeah, again, you know what they're trying to do, have a little bit of balance. They're running both sides. Trying to keep this defense honest.
Simcoe, the wide out to the left. Hummel's just off the line to the right side. Rex is in the slot on the left side. They're going to send Hummel in motion again. They're going to hand that football off, and that's Beckwith. He's going to get knocked back for a loss on the play back near the 20-yard line. That's going to be a loss of about 6 yards. So it's up a third down here in 15.
That'll bring up a third and 15.
Yeah, that time. Very well read. That's a good example there of what happens if a defensive player stays at home. Everybody was home. It will make the tackle.
Ferguson back under center, 3rd and 15. Rex went in motion. Ferguson looks to throw, flushed out of the pocket, threatened to turn outside. He gets outside. He's to the 15, cuts back inside to the 5, and into the end zone. Touchdown, Ferguson, with a 15-yard touchdown run.
Yeah, nice job there out of Ferguson. The big key for that success, Mike, on the play is he made the decision quickly, realized he was going to have to tuck it and run, did so, get 6 out of it.
And coming on for the extra point is Franchino.
But the hold by Christian Simcoe.
Franchino gets ready. Here's a snap to Simcoe. The hold's there. The kick's on the way, and the kick is up. And the kick is good. Clarion area leads it by a score of 7-0. We'll take a quick 30-second timeout. 7-0 Clarion, you're listening and watching Carly Tire High School Football. Explore Clarion, D9Sports.com.
This is Corey. He made two big mistakes. His first mistake was not going to Laurel Eye Clinic to have bladeless LASIK. His second mistake was trying to pet what he thought was his cat without wearing his glasses. Don't be like Corey. Call Laurel Eye Clinic.
Enjoy fabulous fine dining in a casual, elegant atmosphere at the Allegheny Grill in Foxburg. Take in the breathtaking view through the windowed walls or dine on the patio overlooking the always changing Allegheny River.
Media Network.
All right, back here. Tyler got a great shot there of that just gorgeous sky. Just over to our west.
He almost act surprised that he got such a good shot.
No, I mean, he does a fantastic job. He had those... He always finds a really unique shot all the time. Franchino is ready. Here's the kickoff. Ball's going to bounce around and goes out of bounds, so the penalty flag is thrown. See if Kane will just take it.
Kickoff goes out of bounds.
I think they will. It appears so anyways, as you see the rest of the offense come out, and that is indeed what they'll do here, Mike. Now, I think... you know, for Kane, obviously, this is their first opportunity to be out here on offense. They want to be patient.
Ball will be spotted at the 35-yard line for a first and 10 for the
Certainly
wall.
Their big key is to establish the run.
The quarterback is Morris. They're going to set up in an I formation behind him. Zampogna dots the I.
Almost looks like they're checking out of a play here as everybody now looks at the armband again.
Morris ready, takes the snap. Hands that off and right up the gut, running right up the middle of the field and tripped up across midfield with that run. Got to see the number here. That was 36 with the big run that time. And that was Plants.
First down, tackled by Simcoe.
Addison Plants with the run. Sorry, I couldn't see the name here. So Plants getting the carry. Big first down across midfield to the Clarion 47-yard line.
Yeah, that time I think the linebackers, the fake was so well executed they were froze. By the time they reacted, you know, Plants was already a good 10 yards down the field.
Morris under center. Goes to Zampagna now over the right side, and he'll be dropped after about a yard gain. Zampogna with just about a yard is all. We'll see where they spot him. Boy, it looks like not much.
Yeah, I was going to say, there actually looks like they, they're going to move him back to the line. It's a pretty tough sledding.
So second down and 10 here for Kane, the Wolves. Working it here in Clarion territory at the Clarion 47. Going to hand it off. Zampogna again is going to be hit and dropped for a loss this time. He'll lose one back to the 48-yard line. So Zampona getting the carry, and he'll be dropped for a yard loss, second and 11. So third down comes up.
Yeah, and that's a situation there where Zampona realizes that he's in deep trouble. He just wants to secure the football. Did lose the yard on it.
Twins off to the left, twins to the right here for Morris. Like Morris is going to drop back into shotgun formations. Zampona is the sidecar right. Third down and 11. They're going to send Zampona in motion. Ball snap back to the quarterback. Comes back across the right side. Try to get a screen set up there, and it's not going to work. Tried to come back across the field, and he's going to be dropped for a loss back to midfield. That's a two-yard loss.
Yeah, a little bit of a razzle-dazzle, if you will. You know, kind of page 15 in the playbook a little bit. Tried to freeze the linebackers. Obviously, going to go out on a limb. They probably have run that earlier because Central Clarion not fooled at all. Stayed home. Good job on that one. Brings up a punting situation.
Kane ready to punt. Good snap. Punts away. Hummel takes it at his 19. Lost the football, but he gets back on top of it. Boy, we've seen on the kickoff and there on that punt, some trouble with the kicks. So they're going to put him at the 18-yard line.
Yeah.
Morris punting. Punt's brought to you by Janie Montgomery Scott.
You know, as this game unfolds, you may see Central Clarion be a little more aggressive on it. I don't think initially, obviously, that they were setting up for any type of block, but they got great penetration on it.
So here we go. It is Ferguson under center. Hummel went in motion. He's going to give it to Hummel again on that sweep from the right side. And this time Hummel is going to reach out. He'll only get a yard to the 19-yard line, second and nine.
Picks up about a yard.
And for Hummel now, he's got 11 in the ball game.
We'll make it about second and nine.
Clock cruising along here, 6:59, opening quarter play. Great to have you with us.
Central Clarion sits at their own 19-yard line. They lead here 7-0. Rex went in motion. They're going to give it to him as he sweeps left to right, turns the corner, and Rex is going to be dropped out at about the 24, maybe 25-yard line.
Rex on the carry.
That's a gain of 6. And that's going to set up a third down and still about 3.
Yeah, it's a long 3.
Ball just shy of the 25-yard line. Third down and 3 here for the Wildcats of Central Clarion. Oh, Kane was showing blitz the whole way, and they jump off sides. Clarion will get the first down.
Credit that one to Ferguson. Obviously changed his cadence because I'm willing to bet he probably ran the same cadence a couple of different plays in a row. This time, a little bit of a pause. And that was all that it took. It's an easy first down. It doesn't matter how you get the penalty yardage, Mike, or the yardage period to convert on a first down, whether it's by penalty or by an offensive play. It still moves the chains. That's what you've got to do.
So Central Clarion with the first down at their own 30-yard line. They lead 7-0. Ball handed again to Hummel over the left side. Hummel hit in the backfield, but then is able to eke out about a yard to the 31-yard line. Second down and 9.
Well, you can see, Mike, this would be a great opportunity to go to a screen, a draw, something like that, because the linebackers are cheating. They're timing everything on the snap count. They're playing run first and foremost. It would be a great opportunity to run a screen here or a draw.
Second down and 9, ball sitting at the 31-yard line. Simcoe will be the wide out to the right. Ferguson will come under center. It's Beckwith in the backfield. Send the man in motion. That's Rex looking to throw. Ferguson across the middle of the field. He finds Simcoe in stride. First down for Central Clarion. All the way down to the 36-yard line. Here's the replay on that one.
Tackle by
Ackley. See that. Bob talked about a good opportunity to try a screen, but here they're going to throw downfield. There's Simcoe. And Simcoe is going to be spun down at the 36-yard line. Well, they'll say the 37.
Yeah, nice call.
Ball handed off. That's Rex. That sweep from left to right. Rex weaving his way, finding room inside the 30 and then out of bounds. Flags are all over the place, and we're going to have more tacked on to the end of that one. He would have the first down as he took it all the way down to about the 25-yard line. Pick up 12.
And, Mike, if you remember, first couple of times they went to the right, did not have success. The last two times have had success running to this right. What you have to remember when you have a running game, you have to be patient because you're not always going to experience success each and every time you touch the football that way. You have to hang in there, and good things have been happening to this squad, obviously, as they are patient and they allow that run to set up and to develop. And they're also going to benefit here as the 15-yarder has marched off and they are deep in Kane territory once again.
they'll be down near the 12-yard line, and here come the Wildcats. Twins to the left. They're going to send Hummel in motion. They're going to hand that football off. Not a whole lot there that time. I think that was Rex coming from the left side. It was, and he's going to be stopped. He'll actually lose.
How about Zampona that time, Mike, with that solid hit?
Yeah.
It's a good chest-on-chest tackle.
They're going to push him back, actually. He's going to lose about a yard. Second down and about 13, or second down and 11, as that ball's going to be pushed back at about the 13-yard line. 2 men in motion, so this is going to be this will go for naught. Now, in the Canadian Football League, that would be just perfect.
Yeah, that actually would have been a nice call up in Canada because you could see, actually, the defense separated. Unfortunately, however, that just doesn't seem to fly here.
So the penalty is going to back Central Clarion up.
Yeah, and I have to tell you, there was a little confusion, obviously, two players going in motion at the same time. But I like the call because I was getting ready to say, I'm surprised we haven't seen them run up the gut once. They must have seen something in film that indicates them. They feel that they can have success going to that outside. But you still kind of have to run a token play up the gut a little bit. And although it was aided by the two-man motion, they would have had some success at it.
Well, they're in the Dewbrook red zone. Ferguson looking to throw again. Tries to get that to Simcoe, but it's going to be batted down instead. And getting his big paws on that was number 56, Justin Peterson.
It brings up now the third.
Bringing up a third and 16.
Yep, 16 situation here. Really, you got to be looking forward on territory. Play here, you'd like to go to chisel away at some of this, make it more of a fourth and manageable. Certainly, if you could convert the first down, would be fabulous.
Ferguson barks the signals. Here comes Kane. Fires the football, looking for Simcoe. It's incomplete. So fourth down. Now we'll see. I would imagine they're going to just go for it here.
Pressure by Costanzo.
Franchino has a pretty good toe, but I think this is going to be a little too long.
Yeah, just a little too long at this point. Just a little too much muscle, too, on the last pass. Scoreboard still is saying third, but it should be fourth down, I believe.
Yep. There it is over there. .353 to go here in the first quarter. Here's Ferguson out of the shotgun. Fourth and 16 here for the Wildcats. They lead it 7-0.
Backers indicating initially blitz, then they back off.
Do get a timeout taken. Central Clarion will take a timeout. We'll pause too. 7-0 Central Clarion. 3:53 to go here with the first. We'll pause 30 seconds. You're listening and watching Carly Tire High School Football at exploreclarionandedinesports.com.
With so much to protect each day, Eric Schick Insurance and Financial Services is here to help you find the right coverage that fits your life. Call 814-275-2210 to learn more.
Enjoy fabulous fine dining in a casual, elegant atmosphere at the Allegheny Grill in Foxburg. Take in the breathtaking view through the windowed walls or dine on the patio overlooking the always changing Allegheny River.
This is the EYT Media Network.
To fourth down, Central Clarion had to use a timeout. Ferguson looks to throw, fires the football, and it is dropped on the left side by Simcoe. Had to turn a little bit outside for it, but the ball is there. And Kane will come up with a big defensive stand here, and they're going to take over on downs.
Yeah, some nice pressure there. They didn't allow Ferguson time to set up. That was one of the keys I felt top of the broadcast, Mike. They just couldn't afford to give him the time to set up shop. So they will take over. So they dodge a big one there at the 3:50 mark opening quarter play. Still a 7-0 Central Clarion lead.
Well, Morris and crew will try again. They're going to start at their own 19-yard line. Zampona in the backfield here with Morris, who works out of the shotgun. They're going to go trips to the right side.
Single receiver off to the left here for the Wolves. Morris looks to throw, fires the football, and it is going to be picked off by Rex. He's to the 30, 25, 20, 15 to the 10, to the 5, and into the end zone. Touchdown. Picked that off right around the 30-yard line and took it in for the score. What a nice job and a nice read there by Rex. Here's the replay, and yeah, he picked it off right around that 30-yard line. And look at him go as he takes it into the end zone. So 3 minutes and 40 seconds is where that one comes.
Franchino in for the extra point. Pulled by Simcoe.
Here's Franchino. Holds there by Simcoe. Kicks on the way, and that kick is not going to be good. So
it's partially blocked.
Yep. Point is no good.
So 13-0, Central Clarion leads, 3:40 to go here Central in the first. Clarion, we'll buzz. You're listening to Carly Tire High School Football right here on Explore Clarion and D9Sports.com.
Clarion, Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram, proudly supporting high school sports.
West Park Rehab Physical Therapy, providing traditional physical therapy plus diagnostic testing to include EMG nerve conduction study and musculoskeletal ultrasounds.
This is the EYT Media Network.
All right, back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. Central Clarion scoring there is... It is Rex taking that in. That was Bracken Rex. Roughly 30 yards, the interception return for touchdown. Central Clarion leads it here 13-0.
Yeah, what a nice read, Mike. You can tell a little bit of homework done in this ball game.
Welcomes up, taken around the 15-yard line, back to the 20, to 25, 30, and down at about the 34-yard line. That's where... Kane will have it.
So we take a look at that Zocker Motors scoreboard. Some early scores rolling in. Scouter Sports 6, Bucktel 0. Red Bank Valley up 8-0 over Smethport. It is St. Mary's 7, Carn City 0. Two boys in Bradford. Still no score in that one. Everybody at zeros. And Clearfield up 6-0 over Phillipsburg Osceola. So I think for Kane, Mike, you know, you've had the long trip here. You just want to take a deep breath, relax a little bit, get back into your comfort zone and run the football, although this formation indicates that it should be a pass as we've got trips on this left side.
Morris again working out of the shotgun formation. He's going to hand that off and run it with that football across the 40 and near first down yardage. Again, that was Plants, and he'll take it for 10 yards. They're going to move the chains.
I was going to say Plants should have it. Very good job there of executing about Addison Plants. You know, Mike, it's 28 yards, two touches.
Yep,
pretty good. What's the average real quick?
13 and a quarter.
And that's why Dorothy balances your checkbook.
If Dorothy did, I wouldn't have any money. 3:05, clock continues to move here in quarter number one. Morris works out of the shotgun again. Going to give that to Zamora this time, and he's met and dropped in the backfield. Big time hit, and he's going to lose about 5 yards on that hit. That would be a loss of fours. They're going to put him at the 40.
Boy, what a tough shot that is, Mike. Looking on the roster here. Don't seem to have that number in my roster.
Well, we'll find out. So Morris now, it's a second down and 14. Hands that off over the right side. Zampona with that football, and he'll get the 4 yards back as he gets back up near the 44-yard line.
Yeah, that's his fourth touch, Mike, and he has 0 yards. So been tough sledding so far. Here in a third and 10 situation.
So third down and 10 here for Kane.
Taking their time here.
Yeah, Morris will drop back into shotgun formation.
I'm a little spoiled we don't have the down clocks in effect tonight.
Oh, and flushed out of the pocket as Morris fires the ball downfield. Fight for that football. It is caught. It's caught inside the 30, down to about the 28-yard line. Looking to see who's on that far side over there. Bob's got the glasses up.
Hauling that one in is
Harley Morris with a great job of escaping the pocket.
Here's that replay.
Sam Lundeen.
Lundeen with the catch. Look at that. He had to go way up there. He went between two defenders. Takes it down.
Yeah, that looked like your vertical leap, actually.
Mine was higher.
Power positive thing is wonderful.
In 1987. Ball back down to the 27-yard line. No, the kid did a fantastic job. Great job by him. Now Morris working out of the shotgun again. Sends the man in motion. Trips off to the left side. First and 10 at the Clarion 27-yard line. Morris takes his time. Takes the snap. Keeps the football over the right side. He's got room to run. He's to the 20, to the 15. That's a first down in the Dewbrook red zone. As Morris takes it down, they're going to say he stepped out at the 15-yard line.
And that'll be enough for the first
so
down.
That's a big first down there for Kane. I'm trying to think where he got started. Bob's already looking at it.
Yeah, at the 37-yard line.
First and 10.
So that's a blue, what a 17-yard pickup.
Yeah, nice, effective run.
Ball snap back to Morris again. Morris looks to throw, fires that pass, and it's incomplete. Was trying to get that in between a couple defenders down there. Szymanski was the intended
Morris
receiver.
Morris' pass ball's incomplete.
So Szymanski down there. I know Dave's not going to try to say it. But anyone with ski on the end of their name, all right, my book. Trips off to the left, single receiver off to the right. Morris, second down and 10. The ball sitting at the Clarion 15-yard line. Kane driving here, looking to put some points on the board. Here's a little delayed handoff. And running with that football over this left side, that would be Bakakis. And he'll take that inside the 10, down near the 9-yard line. That's about a 6-yard pickup. Sets up a third down and 4.
About 6 yards, bringing up the third and 4.
Seeing a bunch of different guys touching the ball here for Kane.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea for them. They got some fresh legs out there. And also, they're showing some multiple looks here. Hoping to catch the Wildcats off guard.
Morris in the shotgun. Third down and 4. The ball at the 9-yard line, looks to throw to the right side. It's caught. Nope, incomplete. That far side of the end zone. Pass comes up incomplete.
Morris's pass for Dar falls incomplete.
So 2 seconds here in this first quarter. So get another play here on fourth down.
I think a couple of Bobcat defenders, Mike, able to read that one. A few of the offensive linemen were tilted, indicating they were going to pass. So
fourth and 4 from the 9-yard line. Morris is ready. Plants will come up sidecar left. Watch for him. I'll tell you what, he's a bull. Morris is going to keep the football. Comes over the left side. Here's Morris tripped up, and he'll have the first down as he takes it inside the 5 and down near the 3. And that's where we'll end quarter number 1. And we'll go to quarter number 2. Central Clarion leads at 13-0. We'll switch sides of the field and come back with more. You're watching the Carly Tire High School Football Game of the Week. It's here on exploreClarion and D9Sports.com.
best wishes to our local teams for a safe and successful season from your one-stop car, truck, and SUV dealer, Clarion Ford, Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, and Ram. Visit us on Main Street in Clarion or start online at clarionauto.com.
This is the EYT Media Network.
Oh, here we go. Back to action. Kane trying to put one here on the scoreboard. Zampagna back in there. They're going to set up in the I formation. Plants will be the fullback. Morris is under center. Going to take that snap, hands that off to Zampagna. He's hitting the backfield, spun around, keeps his feet, but he's going to be drugged down. Zampona is going to be dropped back near the 5-yard line. That's a loss of close to two. So it'll be second and goal from the 5-yard line.
Yeah, Zampona came into this ball game as the team's leading rusher, Mike, but on five attempts, he's stuck at minus 2 yards. So Central Clarion really focusing on him.
So second down and goal from the 5-yard line here for the Wolves as they try.
Could be a great time to go to Plants here.
Plants goes in motion. Sets up to the right side, and we get a timeout taken by Kane this time. So we do have that.
And that's a big break because they actually had two guys in motion, so took the timeout prior to the infraction occurring.
And we do want to let you know, too, the second quarter is sponsored by Hager Paving of Strattonville. Hager Paving is up the road there in Strattonville. Autumn Leaf Festival kicking off here this weekend in Clarion, so if you're out and about, get down for that. Dustin will be taking the kids up for all the rides and all the great food and fun.
Dustin, because he's independently wealthy, can do these things.
I just sit at home and cry. No one asked me.
With all your friends.
We're in the second quarter, 11-18, just underway here. 13-0 Central Clarion leads, but will be a second and goal from the 5-yard line for Kane as they try to get on the board here. Central Clarion scored on a Ferguson 15-yard run, and then Brecken Rex, that 30-yard interception return for a touchdown.
Looking around, Mike, some scores of interest on that Zocker Motor scoreboard. It is Brookville 7, Montauk 0. County up 14-0 over Bucktail. Brockway 7, Otto Eldred 0.
Well, here we go as Morris will work out of the shotgun. He's got Plants, the car left. Wouldn't doubt they might try to go to him. Send a man in motion left to right. Morris looks to throw, fires that football, and it is off the fingertips of the intended receiver over here on the right side.
Morris's pass for Dar, ball
and
incomplete.
That was Dar.
Bringing up a third and goal from the
five. Intended receiver.
So that is the sixth pass attempted.
So third and goal here for Kane.
On the coverage.
Clock stops on that incompletion.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, I like the look how Plants runs the football. I think you got to look towards him in this situation. He's had success tonight.
Sidecar right. It'd be four down territory, I would imagine. They're going to give that to Plants over the left side, and Plants banging his way down and into the end zone. Touchdown,
that
Kane.
Plants
are in the end zone, and it's a score here for Kane.
Cutting the lead to 13-6.
Yeah, nice run. Simple, nothing fancy. That guy just runs the ball effectively. At that time, the offensive line doing a great job of opening up a hole, but Plants, he's able to easily find the end zone.
So, on for the extra point, I believe. Are they going to go for two here? I think they're going to go for two.
The Oklahoma shift, depending if there's any reaction. There's too many men in the huddle. Actually, no. He's going to run back. They'll bark out a call. They're yelling shift, so they'll rotate in. You still got to play it honest if you're out there on the defensive side.
Walker attempting the extra point with a hold from Morris.
Flag on the play.
It took way too much time.
And we've got a delay.
There you go.
Delay of the game against Kane.
So they're going to back him up 5 yards. And leave Walker out there. Time it'll be 25-yard attempt for that extra point. Walker steps it off.
Good news is it's ideal kicking conditions. No wind at all. No moisture.
Snaps there. Holds there. Kicks on the way. And the kick by Walker's no good. So there we go. It is 13-6 our score as Clarion leads Kane. We'll take a quick time out. You're watching Carly Tire High School Football and Explore Clarion. D9Sports.com.
Dubrook, a proud member of the M&B Group.
Can afford a gorgeous custom-designed hardwood Kale's kitchen for a lot less than you'd pay at a DIY store. Go to factorydirectkitchens.net. At Kale's, there are never middleman markups or hidden charges that can add 40%. Go to factorydirectkitchens.net. That's factorydirectkitchens.net.
You're locked on to the EYT Media Network.
All right, right back to action. Tyler getting a good shot there. Those Kane folks across the way. Back to take the kick here for the Bobcats is Ashton Rex, but kick's going to come up a little bit short. And over this left side, dropped at about the 25-yard line. That is where Central Clarion will have it. That was Breckenrex coming up with it. It's Memorial Stadium in Clarion. Fantastic evening.
Mike, absolutely love where we're sitting here.
Yep.
It's you know, so much, for me anyway, so much easier than when we were in the box, got to admit.
So here comes Central Clarion. Ferguson under center. He's going to hand the football off, but we have a whistle.
Indication was offside.
Offsides against the defense, so they blow it dead. A lot of times you get a free play out of that.
Yeah, now what they're trying to do, Mike, is they're literally selling out. They're trying to time the count. If you want, you can go ahead and change your count up a little bit almost at any point in time, probably able to pick up those 5 yards.
So Ferguson and crew, first and five. They're going to go up at the 30-yard line now after that penalty. Ferguson under center. Beckwith behind him. And Rex went into motion. And the handoff, though, comes from the other side. And that's Hummel getting the carry. Crosses the 40. That'll be a first down out near the 42-yard line.
Hummel takes it for 12 and a first down.
And there you go. It's a first down here for Central Clarion. That's an Allegheny Grill first down.
Brought down by Morrison Plants.
Yeah, Hummel now 4 attempts, 23 yards in the ballgame. Very methodical approach. And, you know, Kane, Mike, just about each and every down they have blitzed.
10, handoff here to Breckenrex. He's hit, bumped in the backfield, but eludes a couple. Hit, here he goes. He's off to the races, 50, 45, and then out of bounds. And they're going to say he steps out at about the 43-yard line.
Gain of 15 on that one.
Just inside the 45.
And moving the chains. You know, this is a credit actually to Central Clarion because obviously Kane is gambling on that run. They're coming at him. This offensive line still doing a good job of throwing the key blocks. All the ball carriers have experienced success as they're able to pick up positive yardage.
Ball's at the 43. Handoff goes right up the gut this time. Not a whole lot there either. Going to have a gain down around the 40. It's still about 3 yards on the pickup.
Yeah, that was Braylon Beckwith that
time. Beckwith
getting the carry and sets up a second down here in 7. Hager Paving second quarter here on the EYT Media Network. Glad you could be with us tonight. Mike Kalinowski, Governor Bob Dunkel, Dustin Kiefer, Tyler Oaks all here.
True ball control offense.
Ferguson looks to throw. Fires the football. He just slung it down there. It's caught inside the 10. And that's Simcoe into the end zone. Touchdown. How about that? 40 yards for the touchdown.
Oh, and love the move at the end.
Take a look at that again.
From 40 yards out.
And you can just see it. He just almost like sidearmed it. Wham. And then there was Simcoe. Knocks down the defender and into the end zone.
Yeah, what a nice, nice run. Nice catch, nice run.
Certainly did, Governor. Franchino. Extra points on the way. Boy, that's a good one. As it's up and good, 9:45 to go.
You're going to have to run to Interstate 80 to recover that ball because there was that much of leg and muscle behind it.
Let's take a quick timeout. It is 20-6. Clarion leads. You're watching Carly Tower High School Football. Explore Clarion, D9Sports.com.
The Cooper Discoverer 8.
Located in Parker, Emlinton, and Clarion, UFP Parker LLC is currently hiring for several skill levels, including general labor, assembler, and forklift operators. For more information, visit ufpi.com/careers.
You can afford a gorgeous, custom-designed hardwood Kale's kitchen for a lot less than you'd pay at a DIY store. Go to factorydirectkitchens.net. At Kale's, there are never middleman markups or hidden charges that can add 40%.
It says Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. Central Clarion extends that lead 20-6 now here on Kane.
You know, what a great drive, Mike. You mixed a little bit of run and pass together. Executed very well. Nice long drive.
Kick is picked up at about the 15. Back to the 20, 25, 30, 35-yard line. Out to the 40, 45, 50. And on that run back
he's
was
Campona.
And he's finally pushed out of bounds all the way down near the 30-yard line.
Yeah,
what a run.
What a fantastic tightrope that time. Looked like he was going to go out of bounds back here.
That's what I thought.
At around the 50, 45-yard line. Instead, he gets positive yards, stayed in bounds, and you know, great call. You know, official on top of it.
So Kane sets themselves up in great field position to try to answer that Clarion score.
You know, sometimes you need a big play by your special teams to, you know, give a shot in the arm to the offense. Kane hoping to see that here. Great field position for Kane.
He dropped for a loss on the play back near the 25-yard line. It's a loss of almost, is it going to be a loss of two?
Down by Harley Morris for a loss of two.
Second here and 12.
Making a second and 12.
Yeah, it might be one of those deals, Mike, where you go to the well once too often. Again, very well defended by Kane. I do think you're going to have to go to that passing attack. You've got to keep this defense a little more on the honest side.
You have a whistle.
You have a whistle, you almost going to wonder if it's an equipment issue. I think that's what we're going to see.
Yep. That's Rex coming off there. Fast and Rex. Get that taken care of. So here goes Central Clarion. Second down and 12, Ferguson out of the shotgun. Kane, boy, they want to come here. Now they back off.
Taking a lot of time on this.
They're going to have to be careful, too. Those play clocks are not working. And we have a whistle.
And we have another whistle.
We had to delay a game. I'll tell you what, we could tell it was taking a long, long time.
As a player, you have to develop sometimes that internal clock, that internal sense of urgency. They did not, so paints them in an even deeper corner. And this again, makes it very difficult if you're out there in that offensive side. You know that defense is going to come after you.
So second down now. Ball pushed back to the 30 or the 21-yard line. Second down and 18 here for the Wildcats. They lead by six. Ferguson again out of the shotgun on second down. Looks to throw. Steps back. Steps up. Flushed out. Nope, he's hit. He's dropped. He's sacked.
Ferguson is sacked on the play by Bajakas.
And he'll be dropped for another two-yard loss. Nope, they're going to say 3 yards. Back to the 18-yard line. So it sets up a third and 21.
Yeah, and that's, again, what the defense gets to do. They're going to take full advantage of that. They know it's going to be in all likelihood to pass. You pin your ears back and go right at them.
Third and 21. Long way to go. Here's Ferguson, looks to throw, fires that football. It is caught. That's Simcoe. Has some room, and he's going to be dropped at about the 30-yard line. So he gets back some, but sets up a fourth down and eight. So he picks up about 12, almost 13 of them. But 8 yards shy.
That'll bring up a fourth and nine.
Punting situation.
You can bet.
Ackley's back deep.
You can bet the way Kane is looking here on this return, Mike. They want to apply some extra pressure.
Good snap. Oh, they're going to fake. That's Rex on the fake. He's got it. 40, 45, 50, 45, 40, 35-yard line. Yes, he's finally dropped on that far side of the field. They're going to say his knee went down at the 32. Clarion runs the fake.
Breaking about 40 yards to the 31 of Kane.
Wow.
Here's that replay on the fake. You can see him on that right side. And he just kept churning those legs. And he's dropped at the 31-yard line, and that's where Central Clarion will have it as they run the big fake to keep the drive alive.
That's a huge, huge play, and again, special teams with a big play yet again tonight for these Wildcats.
Quick pass to the right side, caught inside the 25 to the 20 into the Dewbrook red zone.
And complete to Ashton Rex.
Yeah, Rex. I thought that was Rex on that far side. Wanted to make sure. And he's going to take that down near the 15-yard line. But there is there a penalty? It's a hold here. Going to be called against Central Clarion. So this one's going to come back. It goes for naught.
And that's going to go against Central Clarion.
Flag was at the 25-yard line.
Looks like a push in the back.
Brings it back to the 35 and makes it a first down and about 14.
Make it a first and 14.
So Clarion, Central Clarion getting called for the penalty there. Penalties are sponsored by Red Bank Chevrolet. First and 14 from the Kane 35-yard line here for Central Clarion. Ferguson across the middle of the field. The ball's going to be batted down. Good defensive play across the middle.
Yeah, if that bat doesn't take place, you're going to be calling a touchdown.
Dar with the coverage.
I believe that was Dar with.
Yeah, I think that's who.
Dar tipped that away. 5:35 here, Mike. Wildcats threatening, but the hold changes the complexity here.
Second down here for the Wildcats from the 35 of Kane. Second and long. Ferguson comes back, finds Hummel. Hummel to the outside. He's to the 30 and down at the 29-yard line. He'll get positive yardage. Give him about six.
Is well defended by Kane.
And it sets up a third down and eight here for the Wildcats.
Again, nice chunk of yardage. You know, you're trying to chisel away at that, and you do. You get a good call there. Again, you can see Kane caught on last second. They got good penetration. They realized it was too good to be true, so they stopped. Did a decent job. Still 6 yards on that one.
Ferguson will come under center. Twins out to the right side. 4:54 to go here in the quarter. They're going to send Brecken Rex in motion. He gets the handoff. Tries to turn the corner. We do have a flag on the play. And he's going to get about a yard is all down near the 28-yard line, but we'll sort this one out.
I would suspect that we're going to see a hold, but
face mask against Kane.
Wow.
That's big.
I thought we would see a hold based on where that flag is, how deep it is. As they will march it off, and a bit of self-destruction here by the Kane Wolves.
That's just going to be the 5-yarder, so it's still not a first down.
It's going to be the 5-yard variety.
But now you have two downs.
We'll make it a short third down.
To Kane. Just slightly over two.
So third down and two as they have that. It was not a personal foul face mask. It was just the 5-yard variety. So the third and eight becomes a third and two. Ball sits at the 23-yard line of Kane. Here's Ferguson under center, sends Rex in motion, hands that to Rex, and he's going to be dropped. Does he slip? I'm not sure. I didn't see if he was hit or not.
Actually, that was the big man.
That was on that side.
Yeah, Jake Costanzo shooting the gap, basically took his knees out.
Okay, because as he was running away from me, was blinded by Bob, was right on top of it. So fourth down, the ball pushed back to the 26-yard line. That is a loss there of three.
Yeah, I'll admit I have to cheat a little bit. I wear the binoculars.
I'm going to have to. I keep saying that. Fourth and five, ball back at the 26-yard line. Ferguson, quick throw. The pass is incomplete. Kane will take over on downs.
Yeah, big play there by the defense, rising to the occasion.
Tried to get that into Smith.
And we'll turn it over on down.
So 20-14 is where we stand. 3:48 to go here in the second quarter.
Yeah, there's a lot of time here left for Kane. So they want to get in a position certainly to tie this one. Add the conversion, even take the lead, if you will.
We get someone. Go ahead.
They also got to be careful here.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to force anything. And, again, you've had limited success throwing the football tonight. You did have the one touchdown.
Well, Morris will work out of the shotgun. He's got Plant side car right. He's the big guy out of the backfield. They're going to hand that to Plant. And Plant's going to be hit. He's Plant at that time. He's not going anywhere. He's going to be pushed back to the 26-yard line. That's a yard loss on the play, second and 11. Although he's been pretty effective.
I still would feed that guy all night. Again, I talk about patience, and that's one of those situations there. Again, yeah, you lost a yard that time. This guy is good as gold. I'd feed him again and again. Second and 11. Not third down yet.
Nope. Clock moving down to 3:15 here in this Hager Paving second. Morris looks to throw. Pocket starts to collapse. Fires the football, and it is. Is it picked off by Hummel? Let's see what the official says.
There's a flag on this side. Back deep like that, you almost have to figure a hold.
Yeah, the officials are not making a call yet. They're saying Hummel did intercept it. It would have been at the 39-yard line.
They're discussing it over with each other. And based on the reaction I'm seeing initially, it is going to be a pass interference.
Pass interference goes
against the nice interception.
Yep. Yeah, Hummel came back, did a nice job to get his hands underneath it. But Kane will have the first down. And, again, it's a little bit different than the no football or the no fun league. What is that? The other league. It's not an automatic.
The greatest professional sports league that there is.
Oh, no, that's curling. Anyway, the ball's coming out to the 40-yard line. It's a 15-yard penalty. It's usually the spot you see a pass interference called in the other leagues, but it's the same in college too. It's not at the spot. Morris looks to throw. Boy, they're coming right after him. Rolls to the left side. Morris pumps, throws that ball downfield. Now fight for that football, and it's going to fall incomplete on the far side.
And, of course, naturally, a couple of people want to see a pass interference thrown in that one, but not going to have it. Again, 3 minutes. Now you got to start and think, 3 minutes in the NFL or college is forever. High school seems to just evaporate on you.
Yep.
Not fly, it just evaporates off the clock.
So second and 10, ball sitting at the Kane 40-yard line here for the Wolves. They trail Clarion, Central Clarion, by the score of 20-14. Morris out of the shotgun, takes the snap, hands that football off on that sweep, and it doesn't go anywhere. Getting the carry that time was Ackley, and he's going to be dropped for a loss of a couple back to the 38-yard line, sets up a third down and 12. So 2:45, the clock turning now. It's third down and long here for Kane.
You got to think ahead. Of course, the aggressive nature of most teams tends to be you're going to throw here, try and pick up the first down. But remember, if you do and it stops the clock, give Central Clarion some time to work with. I wouldn't be shocked if we see Plants maybe run a draw here, something along those lines.
He reached out for him. Morris is going to run to the left side. Morris has some room. He's to the 40, then slides. Boy, he had room, and then it just Clarion was able to get over there. It's a couple-yard pickup. And it's going to be about a three-yard pickup to the 41-yard line. Fourth down and nine, and the timeout's going to be taken here. Central Clarion will use the timeout. They want to get this football back, and we'll see what they decide to do here. And, again, you want to stay tuned. Coming up at halftime, we'll have the Carrier Insurance Halftime Show. Get you set up on stats from the first half of the game. Bob will have those. We'll check out a little bit from each of the bands as they're on the football field. We'll have all that for you here tonight. Great night here at Memorial Stadium. Next week, a couple games coming your way on Thursday night. We'll be at Keystone High School. It'll be Keystone and Union AC Valley on Thursday night. That'll be a good one. Friday, we'll be down at Red Bank Valley with Bucktail and Red Bank Valley. Of course, I'll have the Clarion University homecoming game on that following Saturday as the Indiana Crimson Hawks come in.
It still doesn't sound right when you say that.
Well, and I also won't say IUP. There's a reason for that.
Get out your 50-50 tickets. Number will be put on.
That goes back a long time ago. It was a joke and just fun between a couple old radio guys.
Hey, you guys are old.
Fourth down and nine. They're going to punt. That's Morris to punt. Gets it away high, short. It's going to bounce and then takes a Kane bounce as it goes down inside the 35 and continues to roll to about the 33-yard line. So it works out okay there for Kane. Could have been a lot worse. So Central Clarion, Bob will have an exact 2 minutes here to work with.
I think obviously depending on what your success is here on first down depends on how aggressive you're going to be. If you're on first down, you get a decent play of 5 or more yards, you're going to be probably aggressive. If you just struggle to get back to the line of scrimmage, you may get conservative, or most likely you will be conservative. Excuse me, Mike, I've got to go pick up my winnings.
Did you win?
Well, it would help if I actually bought a ticket. But
just go up and say, yeah, I lost it. Ferguson looks to throw, swings it out here to Rex. And Rex will get wrapped up as he crosses the 35 up near the 37-yard line.
Ferguson to Rex.
And they'll give him the 38. That's a gain of 5 on the play, second and 5.
5 on the play, making it about a second and a long 5.
And again, that now says you can be a little more on the aggressive side. Good as a timeout is that clock stopped by going out of bounds.
$335.
Mike, if you win it, at some point, obviously not tonight because you were too cheap to buy a ticket, but you need to take me out for dinner.
Why is it always you?
Because I'm financially challenged. I can use all the help I can get.
You're challenged, not financially. Here's Ferguson. Pumps. Looks to throw. Fires across the middle. It's going to fall incomplete. Trying to get that to Simcoe right around the 40-yard line.
Falls incomplete. Brings up a third down.
The nice thing is we've been together long enough. We know each other's weaknesses and faults and can make fun of it.
Well, you know, we may as well laugh at beach crying. Yeah. So, you know, it is what it is.
We talk about Dustin's faults, but that would take the entire broadcast. So, and his students are at home going, mm-hmm. Third down here for the Wildcats. The ball sitting at their own 38-yard line. They lead it here 20-14. Ferguson's throw. It's caught by Simcoe. First down. As he's going to be dropped up near midfield, we'll see the official spot at about the 49-yard line. So that'll move the chains here. The clock will stop as they do that.
For the Wolves. First and 10 from
Minute 39, clock now moving.
Again, really like the play call there.
Ball to 49. Here's Ferguson looks to throw. Again, fires the football. Now it's going to be picked off. That's intercepted on the backside. And coming up with the interception that time was Zampona.
Yeah, I think a little miscommunication on that point as Zampona looked like a center fielder coming up on that one. So the 127 at their own 30-yard line, we'll see how aggressive they will be.
Well, here's the deal, too, because Kane decided to take that opening kickoff. So Central Clarion will get it. I think they're going to be a little more aggressive than you would normally see here, just being down by 6.
See, I probably wouldn't be aggressive. And the reason being, well, again, depending on what happens on on first down. But the reason why I wouldn't, you're this deep in your own territory, you're only one play away from tying it and a conversion away from taking the lead.
Twins on each side here for Morris, who works out of the shotgun. Looks to throw, steps up, rolls to the right side. He's got a little bit of room. He's to the 35, 40, first down, and he's hit, and he's going to go out of bounds near the 44-yard line. Nice job by him. That's going to be a gain of 14. They're going to move the chains.
Again, nice, good decision. Morris didn't hesitate, saw daylight, took off. Great gain there with 14 yards.
Brady Bond, Ackley, wide out to the left. Twin receivers off to the right for Morris.
As a defender, the big key here is you just don't let anybody behind you. Give them the cushion up front. Don't let them get behind you.
Morris looks to throw, fires, and it is incomplete. Almost could have been picked off down there, too.
Yeah, very nearly picked.
That was Brady Quinn down there. For Clarion, Central Clarion almost coming up with that one. So second down and 10 from the 44. Clock at 1:14 to go here in the first half.
That changes things a little bit if you have success there. But, again, remember, you've got 1:14 to work with. You're not blessed with the full complement of timeouts.
Morris to the left side. Looks to throw. Nope, he's going to look to run instead. And he's going to be stopped. Boy, I'll tell you what, he was spun around and down, but he'll get about a yard. Sets up a third and nine, and we do get a timeout taken by Kane with a minute 3 to go here in this second quarter. Again, Hager Paving is our second quarter sponsor. And we'll be checking some scores and stuff too here momentarily. And if you want, you can go anytime, d9sports.com. That's Aqua Motor Scoreboard, where we bring you here, is also located there as well. We'll see if the Chucks coming back.
Well, they're down 14-7. So I suppose that is in theory, that is a step in the right direction for you. It is, as we look at other scores throughout the district. How about this? This has got to be probably the big surprise here. St. Mary's 14, Carson City 0. I think that's a really big surprise for a lot of people out there. Red Bank Valley up 8-6 over Smethport. That game at halftime, it is County 30, Bucktail 6, Rockway 7, Otto Eldred 0, Port Allegheny 8, Union AC Valley 6 at the half. I think, again, I'm really surprised that St. Mary's and Carson City score 14-0, 4:16 remaining quarter number 2 in that one.
So here comes Kane, third down and 9. The ball sits at their own 45-yard line. They trail here 20-14. There's a minute 3 to go here in the second. Morris will work in the shotgun. Looks to throw. Steps up. Fires the football. And that is going to be caught. First down spinning around. That's Darr with the catch. Landon Darr will take it down to the 35-yard line. And that's about 21. What on the play there? 20.
If it's officially 20.
Is there another timeout? There is. So they will stop the clock. The ball's going to be at the 35-yard line. 55 seconds to go here. We'll just stay live here from the stadium.
Yeah, nice job. But remember, the clock works really fast here. 55 seconds. Yes, it'll stop if you pick up a first down. Mm-hmm. But, again, this is the high school level. It's not the NFL. Your favorite quarterback, Tom Brady, could score five times in 55 seconds.
Well, I was just going to say, I despise the NFL, but I'll tell you what, Tom Brady, one of the best of all time. I don't care what anyone says. I want him on my team.
Well, you throw for 80,000 yards. Yep. The defense rests.
Same thing. You know, people gripe and moan about Bill Belichick, too, but all those years, I'd rather have him as a head coach than anybody else, too. I mean, come on.
Yeah, he does one thing well, which is win.
Well, here we go. 55 seconds. Ball to 35 of Clarion. Morris looks to throw again. Fires the football across the middle. Oh, it's dropped. Unable to come up with that one was Lundeen.
And, boy, Lundeen would like another bite at that apple, Mike. He's going to catch that all day in his and even in his dreams at night. But only took 3 ticks off the clock.
So the ball sits still at the 35 of Central Clarion. Just 52 seconds to go here. Kane with Morris in the shotgun, looking to throw again. Pocket starts to collapse, fires the ball down the left sideline, and reaching up and coming down with it, but out of bounds on that far side. So it'll be third here in 10. Only using 6 seconds that time.
Now, of course, the ball does go out of bounds, but I still like where the ball was placed. It's thrown to that outside shoulder. There's virtually no chance whatsoever for a defender to come down with that pick. If your offensive player is able to reel it in, great. Good job. Moves the chains. Otherwise, not a big deal. Come back. You got another bite at the apple coming up here.
Yep, they got two more shots here to get that first down with 46 seconds. Morris to the left side. It's caught. Coming across the right side, 30. And drop, that's, again, Dar with the catch. And he's going to be just shy of the first down marker. They needed 10. He's going to gain, looks like, about 9. He went from the 35 down to the 26-yard line. And I think this might be the last time taken here by Kane with 30 seconds. So fourth and one. This is a big, big fourth down. Kane trails here by 6, still 30 seconds. And they're going to have that football at the Central Clarion 26-yard line.
You always have to be careful as a defense. You know, sometimes the tendency is to sell out, try and make a big play. The reality is play the percentages. Certainly don't want to see them convert here, but don't give up the 6.
Whoa.
Sounds like Dustin is working on the sound system in the press box again.
Well, Dave Constantino's up there, and he was going on about how he hasn't messed anything up. Well, he did here. There you go.
And I guarantee when he comes out of the box and we see him, I guarantee he's going to look over at us.
He'll just put his head down and just get out of the stands. His wife's at home going, I'm embarrassed. But she's used to that.
The good news is she's been down this road. She knows the outcome. It is what it is. She probably has side bets as to how long it's going to take for this to happen.
Oh, probably. Well, here we go. Fourth and one. Morris keeps the football over the left side. He'll have the first down as he pushes down inside and down to the 23-yard line. It's a pickup of 3. Kane quickly to the line of scrimmage. 26 seconds. They're going to have to hurry here. They get everybody set down to 20. Clock running, and he'll slam that football down to stop the clock. So with 18 seconds, Kane will have a second and 10.
And that right there is a difference between high school, NFL, and even college. It, you know, took a little bit of time for everybody to get there, not just the players, the chain gang, everybody in place. A lot of time jumped off the clock. And again, that can be expected. That's going to happen. Just makes it more of a challenge for you on the offensive side here, 18 ticks. This is where you go now to about page 25 for a play, Mike.
So Morris will work out of the shotgun, the ball to 23-yard line of Central Clarion. Morris looking to throw. Fires. He's got a man open, and it is going to be knocked away. Boy, he was open, and then quickly, was that Rex down there that came over to knock it away?
Pass to Ackley is broken up.
Actually, have multiple receivers elected to throw towards Ackley, looking to get the home run ball, if you will. If he throws short, the issue there being because there was so little time, I don't know if they could have got a second play off.
The breakup was actually Hummel. I want to give him credit. So third down and 10 from the 23 of Central Clarion, 11 seconds. They might get the 2 plays. We'll see. Here's Morris ready to go. He looks to throw. And the ball dumped. It's picked off. It's intercepted. That was Hummel down there inside the 5. He's going to have the interception. And that will stop the Kane drive with 6 seconds. And it looks like we're going to go to halftime with Central Clarion leading here by the score of 20-14. And I'm sure where that ball's sitting, they're going to come out. They're just going to take that quick knee and get this one out and over with.
And you want to be careful here. The exchange has to come clean. This is where you'll suck the offensive line in tight and all together. You normally, when you're this deep in a situation, you play almost what we refer to as a goal line offensive line. You bring everybody in tight and just surge forward.
There you go. That'll be the end of the first half. Central Clarion leads Kane by the score of 20-14, and we'll take a timeout. Coming back, the Carrier Insurance halftime show's on the way. And you're watching the Carly Tire High School Football Game of the Week. It's right here on Explore Clarion at D9Sports.com.
The Cooper Discovery.
No matter how cold it is outside, you can keep warm and toasty inside with a built-in the USA super efficient furnace from Luton's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning. Affordable, quiet, and reliable. You can count on your furnace from Luton's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
Hey Julie, nice deck! Did you get that at Tio Nesta Builder Supply?
It's Tio Nesta Builder Supply, and yes, Dave, I did.
Wonder if they sell siding and roofing at Tio Nesta Builder Supply.
It's Tio Nesta, and yes, Tio Nesta Builder Supply has that too. Come on, Dave, you've never been there? They have two showrooms for anything home improvement. Mom got a custom kitchen there, Bill down the street got the materials for his garage. They have this awesome website, www.tionestabuilders.us. You can buy online. They really have everything for the home.
Wow, I'm heading over to Tio Nesta. I know. Tionesta Builders.
Tionesta Builders Supply Home Improvement Center. Family owned and operated since 1958 with locations in Tionesta and Shippenville.
That sounds good. I'll check them out online at tionestabuilders.us.
Zockro Motor Truck Sales in Clarion is an international Diamond Edge certified service department. As one of only 276 such shops in all of North America, you can be sure that when your medium or heavy-duty truck needs service, the job will be done correctly at Zockro Motors. Our work is guaranteed nationwide at any international truck dealer, and our parts and service prices can't be beaten. Our technicians are factory trained and factory certified. Don't trust a shop that just thinks that they can make repairs. Come to Zockro Motors Diamond Edge Certified Service Department. If it's maintenance you need, click ZockroMotors.com or call us for a quote on those jobs too. Our prices are great. Best of all, you know the repair is done right and it's guaranteed. Get your truck service work done at Zockro Motor Truck Sales, 2 miles north of exit 64 Interstate 80 in Clarion. You're listening to the EYT Media Network.
Right back here at Clarion's Memorial Stadium. In the background, we have the band down there from Kane performing. And we're going to get to the Carrier Insurance halftime show. Coming up, we got stats here. Bob's still totaling a few things up. Are you ready?
I am ready to rock and roll, my friend.
All right, let's do it. Here's some stats with the governor.
As we take a look at Kane, 164 yards of total offense, 78 on the ground, 86 through the air. On the ground, it was Harley Morris leading the way, 45 yards, 31 yards out of Addison Plants. Plants adding one touchdown in that total, and 6 yards out of Reese Bichakis. By the way, I apologize if that's not the right pronunciation. Shane Ackley minus two, and Ricky Zampagna minus two as well. Through the air, Harley Morris is 5 of 15 with one touchdown, two interceptions in the ball game for a total of 86 yards. Hauling in receptions, Landon Dar checking in with 3 receptions for 26 yards, and Lundeen checking in. That's Sam Lundeen checking in with 2 receptions, 60 yards, and that one touchdown reception. Again, 164 total yards of offense for Kane. For Central Clarion, 220, and I always use the phrase balance. Well, this is balance. 114 on the ground, 106 through the air. That's balance. That's pretty much where you want to be in this ball game. But as we take a look on the ground, it was Breckenreck, 72 yards. And this one, 21 yards out of Ryan Hummel, 10 yards out of Braylon Beckwith, 11 out of Chase Ferguson. Again, that would account for 114 yards on the ground. 106 through the air. Ferguson, 6 of 13. Does have the one touchdown, one interception to go along with that. Leading the way on receptions is Christian Simcoe. Simcoe does have one touchdown. He's got 95 total yards, 6 yards out of Ryan Hummel, and 5 yards out of Breckenrex. Again, 106 yards through the air, 220 overall for Central Clarion.
Again, those statistics are brought to you by the Laurel Eye Clinic. We're going to take another time out. We'll come back. We'll have more with some of the bands. It's also homecoming here at Clarion area, or at Central Clarion. We saw that out at Clarion Limestone a couple weeks ago. They have the homecoming here tonight here on the Clarion side of it. We'll get to that. 20-14 is your score. We're in the Carrier Insurance Halftime Show. We got scores and some scoring summary and a whole lot more coming up. Governor's Keys in the second half. You're watching Carly Tire High School Football is live on Explore Clarion and D9Sports.com.
Sweet Basil.
Oaks Building Supply is dedicated to providing quality building products to the community. You will always find what you need for your home improvement project and get great advice on how to do the job at Oaks Building Supply. Customer satisfaction is a top priority. Oaks Building Supply, for all your building and lumber supply needs. Located on Route 66 in Lucinda.
Clarion Forest VNA believes the emotional and physical well-being of a patient is enhanced by the patient receiving care in the familiar surroundings of home. Their staff of caring professionals work closely with physicians to administer quality care to meet the needs of each individual. As a pioneer in home health care in Clarion and Forest County, Clarion Forest VNA continue to grow to meet the community's need for in-home care, offering many different services and programs to meet the patient's need. Clarion Forest VNA, located at 271 Perkins.
He's on the 30, he's on the 20, he's on the 10, it's a touchdown!
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools.
Clarion area and Central Clarion. We're at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. We're in the Carrier Insurance Halftime Show. It's 20-14 as Central Clarion leads, getting ready for some home halftime festivities here with the homecoming. So it's a pretty good ball game going on down there near the end zone. I know Tyler was on that too. There's some young folks down there. They'll probably have to shoo them off the field, but for right now, look at this. He pumps. Here's the pass. Boy, it's caught. Look at that. Fakes him on. Gets back to the 10, to the 5, and that's going to be. He doesn't go in the end zone. What? See, I would have went in. I would have been dancing.
Heard the whistle. You know, they figured got to be a stoppage in play.
Yeah, here's one more play. Going to get one more in. Here it is. And it
sign
is.
That man
oh, it's
that
caught. He got his hands underneath it.
Let's take a closer look at that.
So here we go. We do have the replay. Oh, here we go. Here's the pass. Did he get his hands under it? Yeah, I think he did.
I don't know.
Well, we'll have
I'd be throwing a flag on that if I'm telling you. I'd challenge that.
Well, here we go. The Clarion High School marching band coming out there. And we'll try to hear a little bit from those folks. Get your scoring summary and more here in the Carrier Insurance Halftime Show. And here's Clarion's band. We'll have the homecoming presentation, too. We'll bring that to you. I think everybody's just about ready. That game's still going on. They're not leaving.
It is intense down there, partner.
It pretty much is.
Daughter of Matthew and Melanie Best. She is on the Clarion varsity volleyball, basketball, and softball teams. She holds an office in several school organizations, including Vice President of Student Council, Secretary of National Honor Society, and Vice President of the Senior Class. In addition, she is a member of the Stand Together program and is the head editor for the yearbook staff. Jordan is committed to playing softball at Gannon University, and she plans on majoring in applied exercise science to become a physical therapist. Aiden Quinn is the son of Jeff and Heather Quinn. He is the president of the senior class, as well as choir and clarion singers. He is also the vice president of the National Honor Society and the secretary of student council. He held the lead role in both of our school musicals, How to Succeed in Business Without Really Trying, and Newsies. He is also a member of the varsity basketball team. In the future, Aiden hopes to attend a four-year university in New York City, majoring in musical theater. He hopes to one day live in New York City and become a Broadway star, living in a penthouse with his partner, five kids, and two dogs. Our next couple is Isabella Scott and Cole Wren. Isabella is the daughter of Tim and Jody Scott. She participates in concert band, marching band, and pep band. She is also a member of student council and the National Honor Society. Additionally, Isabella is on the track and field team and is captain of the cross country team. After high school, she plans to run track and cross country at Nova Southeastern University in Fort Lauderdale, Florida, and major in biology. Cole Wren is the son of BJ and Megan Wren. Throughout his time at Clarion area, Cole has enjoyed playing on the football team for several years. He is also a member of the Clarion Stand Together program. After his graduation, Cole plans to attend Clarion University with a major in business. He hopes to one day get married and be successful in whatever he chooses to do. Our third couple is Olivia Kaiser and Cam LaPinto. Olivia is the daughter of Phil and Kelly Kaiser. She is a member of the National Honor Society and is the treasurer of youth council at Clarion Area Junior Senior High School. In addition, she participates in the Art History Club. Olivia plans to attend Kent State University, where she will major in fashion merchandising and hopes to one day live in a city with two dogs. Cam LaPinto is the son of Mike and Teresa LaPinto. He currently holds the office of secretary for youth council. His other notable high school activities including working as a part of the yearbook staff and participating in senior high choir. He is also a member of the baseball team. Cam's future plans include furthering his education in medical imaging or respiratory therapy. Next up, we have Natalie Cousins and Cade Phillips. Natalie is the daughter of David and Jennifer Cousins. She is a member of the National Honor Society and the Shakespeare Club. She is the president of Art History Club, the treasurer of Youth Council, and the secretary of choir and clarion singers. She is also a member of the marching band. Natalie plans on attending college after high school as a biology major and hopes to later become a veterinarian. Cade Phillips is the son of Jamie and Marilee Phillips. Cade is a member of the National Honor Society. He also participates in several school organizations such as Clarion Singers, Drama Club, Chess Club, Shakespeare Club, and the Senior High Choir. After high school, Cade plans on attending a five-year program with Clarion University and the University of Pittsburgh for a program in physics before attending grad school for a degree in astrophysics. Our fifth couple is Noelle Anthony and Ryan Alston. Noelle is the daughter of Robert and Bonnie Anthony. She is the current president of the National Honor Society and is a member of student council. Noelle also participates in several varsity sports such as volleyball, softball, and basketball. Additionally, she is a member of the Clarion Singers. Noelle plans to attend college majoring in biology pre-med while also playing softball. she enjoys working with children and helping people, which has led her to pursue a career as a pediatrician. She hopes to one day have a family with lots of kids, a dog, a chinchilla, and a big house with a pool. Ryan Alston is the son of Denny and Emily Alston. At Clarion, he is a member of the golf, cross country, basketball, and baseball teams. Outside of sports, he is also part of Student Council, Choir, National Honor Society, and he is the president of Youth Council. Outside of school, he has had a very successful career racing dirt bikes, thus far winning multiple championships and multiple series. After high school, Ryan plans to pursue a career in the construction industry. The next couple is Peyton Simcoe and Luca Cherico. Peyton is the daughter of Eric and November Simcoe. She is a member of the National Honor Society and is captain of the volleyball team. She also plays both basketball and softball. Her future plans include attending college, having a good job, and living with three cats. Luca Cherico is the son of Fred and Kim Cherico. Luca has been a football player for almost his entire life, starting in second grade at Union and continuing through 10th grade with the Clarion Bobcat football team. He is a member of Clarion Area Stand Together program, National Honor Society, and choir. In addition, he is an active participant in shop classes and is the owner and designer of his woodworking business, Timberline Custom Wood Products. Luca participates in school's work release program, being employed at Nyswanger Construction as a bid estimator and a UAV operator. He is currently wrapping up his community service project towards earning the rank of Eagle Scout and also serves as volunteer junior firefighter with the Shippensville Elk Volunteer Fire Department. Luca has already accepted a job offer for high school. High school to work at Nyswanger Construction, working as their construction project cost estimator, covering Clarion County and Pittsburgh Tri-County region. Last but certainly not least, we have Corinne Burns and Milton McElreeby. Corinne is the daughter of Joe and Jody Burns. She is a member of the National Honor Society, Student Council, and Art History Club. Corinne is also a captain of the Clarion volleyball team. She also plays for the Revolution Volleyball Club and is verbally committed to St. Francis Volleyball. Corinne plans to attend St. Francis University and major in occupational or physical therapy while playing volleyball at the collegiate level. She hopes to one day have a big family with many dogs. Milton is the son of Robert and Kathy McElreeby. He is the president of Student Council as well as the public relations officer in the National Honor Society. He is also a past member of the varsity golf and cross country teams. After high school, Milton hopes to attend Cornell University and study political science. Let's hear it for our 2021 homecoming court and escort. To crown the king and queen, I present to you our reigning homecoming king and queen, Mr. Brian Acey and Miss Jenna Miller. Brian is the son of Brian and Jody Acey. He is currently attending the University of Pittsburgh as a biology major with a chemistry minor on the pre-medical track. Jenna is the daughter of Sean Miller and the late Tracy Miller, a 2021 valedictorian of Clarion area. Jenna is currently completing a six-year program at Gannon University to obtain a doctorate degree in physical therapy. And now, for the moment you've all been waiting for. This year's homecoming king is Aiden Quinn. And this year's homecoming queen is Jordan Beth. Congratulations to our 2021 homecoming king and queen and all of our homecoming royalty.
Well, there you go. The homecoming here at Central Clarion. We had the one at Clarion Limestone a couple weeks ago, and we have the one here on the Clarion area side. So they all get to participate in that, and we're in the Carrier Insurance halftime show as we roll along here. And the scoring summary from the first half, we've got to get that in for you. When we take a look at that, that is brought to you by Gatesman's Auto Body. Central Clarion got on the board the first two scores. Ferguson, the 15-yard touchdown run, and then Rex, the interception return, 30 yards for the touchdown. Both kicks, first kick was good, the second kick failed. 13-0 after the first quarter. Quarter number two, Kane would get on the board at the 11-11 mark. His Plants would go on a 5-yard touchdown run. The Walker kick failed. It was 13-6. Central Clarion would answer at the 9:45 mark. It was Simcoe, 40 yards from Ferguson. The Francisco kick was good, and it was 20-6. And then Kane would come right back and get a score to make it 20-14, where we're at right now at the 8:52 mark. Lundeen took the pass from Morris, 31 yards for the score. The two-point conversion was run in by Morris, and that's where we stand. We're here at halftime. And why don't we take... Well, we're just going to keep it here. We see the team's getting warmed up. We'll get some scores here momentarily. All right, we are going to take a quick break. I do see they do put 3 minutes back up on the clock as the band's just coming off the field. Why don't we take a timeout? We'll be back with more 20-14. Carrier Insurance Halftime Show continues right here, Carly Tire High School Football on Explore Clarion and D9Sports.com.
With so much to protect each day, Eric Schick Insurance and Financial Services is here to help you find the right coverage that fits your life. Call 814-275-2210 to learn more.
Hi, my name is Jason, and welcome to Sweet Basil. Come on in.
This is Corey. He made two big mistakes. His first mistake was not going to Laurel Eye Clinic to have bladeless LASIK. His second mistake was trying to pet what he thought was his cat without wearing his glasses. Don't be like Corey. Call Laurel Eye Clinic.
Best wishes to our local teams for a safe and successful season from your one-stop car, truck, and SUV dealer, Clarion Ford Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram. Visit us on Main Street in Clarion or start online at clarionauto.com.
West Park Rehab Physical Therapy, providing traditional physical therapy plus diagnostic testing to include EMG nerve conduction study and musculoskeletal ultrasounds.
Enjoy fabulous fine dining in a casual, elegant atmosphere at the Allegheny Grill in Foxburg. Taking the breathtaking view through the windowed walls, or dine on the patio overlooking the always changing Allegheny River.
You're listening to the EYT Media Network.
And back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. Saw that shot Tyler had there. A lot of those bugs up around the lights. He was kind of enthralled with that, but he always gets the good shots. Tonight he did a great job there with the homecoming, and now we get set for third quarter action, and the third quarter sponsored by Zocro Motors. That wraps up the Carrier Insurance halftime show. Kane will be kicking off to Central Clarion.
Yep. There's the kick, and it's good to take that penalty. I'd say march it back. Let's do it all over again. Well, you know, again, big key here for Clarion is come out, get your foot back on the accelerator, move the football with some success, get some points on the board. I think they've done a decent job, Mike. You know, they've held Kane to just 164 yards to the offense. For Kane, they got to come up with a big play or two, force a turnover, take advantage of it.
Well, here come the Wildcats. They'll start at their own 35-yard line after that penalty. Ferguson. Rex went in motion, gives that to Rex over the right side. Here's Brecken. Rex turning the corner, 40, and then out of bounds. And flags on the play.
Yeah, that's going to cost him because the tackle actually occurred. Contact initially occurred as both players were still in the white, and the tackle occurred actually as Rex was long out of bounds.
He picked up like 9, and we're going to have a hit out of bounds. Had 15 on the end of that one. So that'll take it all the way over to the Kane 40-yard line, and that's where.
Yeah, it's not certainly the recipe to success to start out the second half for Kane. As the ball will be placed right at that 40-yard line.
Central Clarion looking for that first win of the season. They're 0-4. Kane came in at 3-2. Ball sits at the 40-yard line. They're going to send Hummel in motion. Hummel gets that jet sweep from the right side. And Hummel's going to be hit, and he's going to be dropped. After a gain of about 2, maybe 3, we'll see where they spot that football. Took a big hit there at the end.
Yeah, good job there by Kane of stringing it out, because what happens, the ball carrier will eventually run out of real estate. You keep him on your outside shoulder, because he's only got one area to go to. If he cuts back in, he's going to turn into you. If not, he's just going to go out of bounds.
Second down here for the Wildcats as they're in Kane territory. That big penalty, that late hit, put them into Kane on the Kane side of the football field. Ferguson looks to throw, fires that football, and it is going to be incomplete. Tried to find Hummel there on the right side, and it's incomplete. Third down now.
Nice play call. Good pressure put on by that big defensive front for Kane. Forced to throw a little bit early, but was Ferguson there. But no harm as the ball goes incomplete.
So third down here in 7 for the Wildcats. They lead it here by 6, just underway here in quarter number 3. I think someone might have been lined up offsides for Kane, but no whistle. And they're going to hand that to Rex, and he's hit and dropped in the backfield. That's a loss on the play. That's going to push him back near the 42-yard line. That's a loss of 5. And it'll set up a fourth down and 12. And here's one. Do you keep your offense on? You try to maybe punt in?
I would punt, try and pin him deep. Your defense has played well. If you punt, can contain them, you'll get the ball back in good field position, but it looks like they're going to go for it with this formation.
Yeah, Smith, Hummel, and Simcoe are the wideouts to the right, single receiver off to the left side. Ferguson will work out of the shotgun. Kane coming right after him. Here's the ball on the left side. He's got Rex breaking free. It's caught. 5, touchdown. 42 yards. Ashton Rex with the touchdown.
Touchdown, Wildcats.
Wow.
Nice play, very well executed, and just like that.
There's Rex going in for the score on that great replay. So Central Clarion getting more points on the board here.
A fantastic play call. I really thought that they would kick, but the aggressiveness pays big dividends as they're able to capitalize.
Here's the kick. It's on the way. Wow. Kick is up and good. Yeah, he put that deep. 10:23 to go here in the third quarter. It's now 26-14. Make that 27-14 in favor here of Central Clarion. We'll break. You're listening and watching Carly Tire High School Football. Explore Clarion, D9Sports.com.
Clarion, Ford, Chrysler.
You're locked on to the EYT Media Network.
All right, back here. 26-14, so they're saying the extra point wasn't good.
Yeah, it
must be. Well, he kicked it long enough, but they're going to say it was no good. So we're going to come back. We'll correct that. I thought they said it was good.
I thought it was good. I just put my head down. It was deep for a country mile.
That's where they have the score. I'm going to put a little asterisk by that just to make sure. Oh, there it is.
There it is. I was going to say, I thought, wow. How could he? The only thing I could think of is somehow it slipped just outside on top of the goalpost. But
I don't know how. I'll tell you what, he kicked that a country mile.
Yeah, that was a country mile. It was clear back just shy of the track.
So here we go as Kane will take over here after the kickoff. And a run right up the gut, banging around, and that is Ampona getting the carry. Nice run by him as he takes it out to the 38-yard line. That's a gain of six, and it sets up a second and four.
That gets Zampona into positive yardage for the first time in quite some while. It's six attempts on for 6 yards in the ballgame.
Second down and four here for the Wolves. They now trail by the two scores. Ball handed off and another run. That's a first down carry out across the 45, and that is Morris with the run that time.
Morris that time elected just to keep the ball and go straight forward. Moves the chains. He's very effective, a good quarterback keeper. Runner, that is.
So here we go. As Kane with a new set of downs in Allegheny Grill, first down here for the Wolves. Ball at their own 46-yard line. They trail, as we said, 27-14.
Taking a lot of time here.
Morris under center, pitches the ball back. Zampona looks a room on the left side. Not a whole lot there. And he's going to get, boy, I'll tell you what, he got about a yard maybe two, and then he was pulled right back. And it looks like they're just going to say it's one as he takes it out to the 47-yard line.
Yeah, that was a well-earned 1 yard at that. Yeah, Wildcats in great position. You can see that the coaching staff really has done a fantastic job of scouting. They've got these guys in position to make plays. They've been able to make them really throughout most of the night.
Backs are in the I formation. Morris sets up under center. They're going to give that to Zampona. And he's going to be hit, and he's going to be dropped. He'll lose a yard back to the original line of scrimmage. Sets up a third down and 10.
Caleb Keel on the tackle.
Kane has not had a ton of success right now running the football, Mike, but I like the patience. You have to come back. You got to stay with it. Makes it a challenge here, and it's a long third down play.
Third down and 10 for the Wolves. Clock down to 8:10 to go here in this Zocro Motors third quarter. Morris will work out of the shotgun here on third and long. Clarion's coming. And quarterback Morris is going to run. Morris, first down. He's to the 40, to the 35. Stays up and finally brought down at about the 31-yard line. What a job by Morris. Boy, he looked dead to rights.
Yeah, the timing was there. The blitz was there. The only problem is the tackle didn't happen as he was able to get away. Big chunk of yardage there for Morris.
They'll put him at the 32-yard line.
Give him 22.
Kane driving now. They send the man in motion. Morris, swing pass back to the right side. It is caught, and not a whole lot there. That was Szymanski. So give him about two down near the 30-yard line. Second down and eight here for the Wolves.
It'll make it second and eight.
Yeah, Morris now 88 yards passing in the ballgame.
So they edge further into Clarion territory to the 30. 7 minutes to go here in this third. Morris out of the shotgun trips off to the right side on the short side of the field. Hit in the backfield, plants, and he's going to be dropped. He'll lose about a yard back to the 31-yard line. Haven't seen him carry many for a loss, but plants that time got hit in the backfield.
I think that play, they had to get the snap off a little quicker. took a little too long to get set up, get established, get that snap off.
Got 6 minutes and 30 seconds on a moving clock.
Trips out to the left, single receiver off to the right side. Morris will work out of the shotgun, third down and 9 from the Central Clarion 31-yard line. Morris looks to throw. Pocket starts to collapse. Now he's going to run to the right side, fires the ball downfield. It's caught! It is caught! And that's inside the 20 in the Dewbrook red zone, down to the 18-yard line. And Dar will come up with the catch that time to move the chains from the 31 down to the 18. Gets again to 13.
13 in that one.
Be first and 10 from the 19.
So Kane making some things happen on third and long. Trips to the left side. And the ball handed off. Looking to run and into the about the 10-yard line. Getting the carry that time. I believe that's Dar. Or was that 22?
It was 22 on
that one.
So
22, Ackley will get the carry. So Ackley will take that down to the about the 10-yard line. Second down and 2.
Like an 8-yard gain. Bring up a second and
a nice gainer there for Ackley.
Morris in the shotgun. Watch for him to run here. I'll tell you what, he's been effective on the drive.
He's going to come up under center again.
Yep, Plants is back there with him. And he's going to keep it over the right side. Bangs around, stays on his feet, falls forward. He'll have the first down. Yep, he's going to take that down near the 7-yard line. So the quarterback keeps it. It'll be a first and goal now for Kane.
Initial contact by Colton Bradley.
Yeah, I think every Bobcat defender, or every Wildcat defender, excuse me, was well aware it was going to be a quarterback keeper, but just couldn't stop it as Morris found that crease.
So they're going to say it is at the, is that at the about the 6-yard line is where it sits. Ball snap back to Morris, looks to throw, fires the football, it's incomplete. So that'll stop the clock with 4:27. With that clock moving right along here too, as Kane just methodically working down the field.
Brings up second and goal.
And my couple of scores of note, it is St. Mary's 21, Carn City 13, midway in the third quarter. DuBois 42, Bradford 0. Your Chucks still losing 14-7.
Flies.
Red Bank Valley pulling away from Smethport 21-6.
Morris in the shotgun, plant sidecar right. He trips, keeps his feet somehow, and Morris is going to take that down inside the 5, down to about the 4, maybe the 3-yard line, would set up a third and goal.
And Morris is injured on this one.
I'll tell you what, that was a tough one from the get-go. He stumbled. And this will be a tough one here, and we hope everything's just okay as they come to attend to him. But he stumbled coming out of there. Looks like, I don't know if he got tripped up or something.
He lost the ball, yeah. And then, you know, had a tough time getting a handle on it, but was alert enough, you know, able to pick that ball up. Mike, as they take a look at him, we'll recap all the scores so far. Goodwin here, Port Allegheny 8, Union AC Valley 6. Rockway 13, Otto Eldred 0. It is Countersport 30, Bucktail 18. Red Bank Valley up 21-6. That's after three quarters of play. It is Brookville pulling away from Montauk 26-0. DuBois 42, Bradford 0. Ridgeway 21, Punxsie 13. Clearfield 49, Phillipsburg Osceola 0. That at the 407 mark in quarter number 3. And again, big surprise to me as I look through all these scores, it is St. Mary's 21, Carn City 13 in quarter number 3.
Well, they're still attending there to the quarterback, Morris. Why don't we take a timeout here, and we'll let them attend to him, and we're going to come back. It's 27-14, Central Clarion leads Kane, and you are watching the Carly Tire High School Football Game of the Week. It's right here on Explore Clarion at D9Sports.com.
Carry Carrier Insurance.
Located in Parker, Emlinton, and Clarion, UFP Parker LLC is currently hiring for several skill levels, including general labor, assembler, and forklift operators. For more information, visit ufpi.com/careers.
You can afford a gorgeous, custom-designed hardwood Kale's Kitchen for a lot less than you'd pay at a DIY store. Go to FactoryDirectKitchens.net. At Kale's, there are never middleman markups or hidden charges that can add 40%. Go to FactoryDirectKitchens.net. That's FactoryDirectKitchens.net.
Dubrook, a proud member of the M&B Group, is the right choice for your next concrete project. Specializing in decorative concrete products, precast concrete products, gravel and stone delivery, Dubrook has what you need to complete your residential or commercial project. With locations in Clarion, Dubois, St. Mary's, Butler, and Evans City, Dubrook is ready to offer their professional help as your ready-mix supplier. Call 1-844-DUBROOK today.
You're locked on to the EYT Media Network.
All right, so Kane now faced with a tough situation. Morris gets up off the field under his own power. Great to see. They hooked their time with him, and he's ready to go. And now they have a third and goal. The ball sitting at the 3-yard line. To see who's the quarterback down there now, Robert. What number do you got?
Actually, it looks like they're going to go to a Wildcat here.
So they will go with the Wildcat setup. Zampone going to snap it to him. They're going to hand that football off, and that is Plants. And Plants is going to go into the end zone for the touchdown. So Plants takes it in from 3 yards out. And Kane right back in it here. That comes at the 401 mark. So Plants with the 3-yard scamper.
Took the handoff from Zampona.
Yeah, nice. Just a simple high percentage safe play. We've got this Oklahoma shift set up here for the extra point. Although now it's just a true 2-point conversion formation.
Again, they'll keep that set up. Zampona.
Zampona.
I'd run the same exact play.
Yep, in the shotgun. They're going to send Plants in motion. Ball snap back to Zampona. He's going to roll to the left side. Zampona looks. Fires that, and it is going to be
incomplete.
So there you go. 27-20 is where we stand. And we'll take a break. It is Carly Tire High School Football on Explore Clarion at D9Sports.com.
How cold it is outside, you can keep warm and toasty inside with a built-in the USA super efficient furnace from Luton's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning. Affordable, quiet, and reliable, you can count on your furnace from Luton's Plumbing, Heating, and Air Conditioning.
This is the EYT Media Network.
9,
all right, here we go. Back to action. Kane back on the board. Makes it a one-score game now, 27-20.
Mike, we do have a big change in that scoreboard. It is now St. Mary's 21, Carnes City 21.
Ooh. Gremlins waking up.
Ashton Rex deep for the Wildcats.
I'd say so. That's at the end of three quarters of play.
Rex the deep man. Take it back to the 20, 25-yard line, up to the 30. And finally out near the 35-yard line. We'll see where they put him down, and that's where Central Clarion will have it.
This is a really big series here. You know, you got to think momentum shifted based on the last score. You want to be confident as you come out here as an offense. You can't go conservative. Get the ball a good field position to start this series out, 35-yard line.
Simcoe will be the wide out here to the left. Then Hummel in motion. They're going to go that sweep from the right to left. He cut left back right. And he's going to pick up close to three out near the 38-yard line. It's like about second down here in seven.
Yeah, Hummel that time. I think the play is designed to kick to the outside. He realized that there was no real estate to work with. Good job on his part to get positive yardage out of it.
Yep, they'll say officially 2 yards, second and eight.
Four-man front has done an outstanding job for Kane tonight in applying pressure.
Ferguson under center. Kane shows blitz. Ferguson hit, and he's going to be dropped. He had nowhere to go. They were coming right after him. He sacked on the play. That's going to be a loss on the play of 5 yards back to the 32-yard line.
Yeah, that's a tough one, and when you see one coming like that, sometimes you want to take your time on that snap count and hopefully that they step into that neutral zone. Brings up a third and long now.
Third and 13 here for the Wildcats.
We got a good matchup on that far side.
Ferguson looking to throw. Steps up, fires across the middle of the field. The ball is incomplete. There were two receivers there. It looked like Humble might have got a hand on the ball first. It was high. Rex was behind him. It falls incomplete.
And the ball had to be thrown high in that situation. If it's thrown low, you have two defenders also in the area in coverage that have a chance to pick it off. You know, you're throwing it high to give your receiver an opportunity, a chance to make the play. If he does, great. It moves the chains. If not, not all drives that end in a kick are a bad thing.
Aston Rex to punt here. And they're going to fake it again. Rex finally punts, and it's going to be very short. That ball's going to be right around the 35-yard line of Central Clarion. They tried to go with the fake, and then Rex decided to punt. And this is going to give Kane fantastic field position, trailing by 7 points here. Still 2:21 to go in the Zocro Motors third. So the ball rests at the 35-yard line of Central Clarion.
Great opportunity here for Kane. You know me in this situation, I would be aggressive, throw down the field if you can, but a lot's going to depend whether or not Morris is able to return out here.
It's not going to be Zampona, still running the quarterback position. Ball snap back to Zampona. He's going to keep the football. Zampona over the left side breaks a couple tackles, and he'll get some positive yardage out of it. He was hit a couple times in the backfield, but he'll take it down to the 32-yard line. It's second down here in seven. Clock turning down now to about 2:05. Ball at the 32-yard line of Central Clarion. Zampona running the quarterback position now with Morris out. Plants will be sidecar right. Twins on each side for Zampona. Takes the snap, gives it to Plants. Here's Plants with it. Plants breaking tackles, spinning, and he'll be brought down near first down territory. Looks like he might just be a little shy. Needs the 25.
Yeah, I think he's going to be. I thought at first he had it. It looks like with this spot, he is just going to be about a couple inches shy.
Yep, they're gonna. That's close to 7 yards on the play. Zampona will come under center. I would imagine he'll keep it here. Ball snapped to Zampona, and he's gonna surge for it. He'll have the first down. Needed one. He's gonna gain close to two as he takes it down to the 24-yard line.
They'll make it a first and ten from inside
inside the 25. Looks like about
it moves the chains.
Oh, they're going to move him ahead to the 23. That's a great spot.
As we approach a minute remaining,
so he gains about
quarter.
Three.
Wildcats looking to come up with a turnover here. You got to bet everybody out there defensively is thinking it's going to be run all the way. But you still got to play honest in case there is that potential pass play.
Zampona in the shotgun. Keeps the football, comes left side. Takes that football down to the 20 and inside the 20-yard line. Looks like it about... See where they spot him. I don't want to call it yet. Looks like just inside the 20. Just it is. It's close to the 19, so he's in the Dewbrook red zone.
Going to give him 15 on 11 attempts tonight.
It's close to four, so it's either a short seven or long six.
Good chance this is going to be the last play here, quarter number three.
Ball's at the 19. And they may not even have to snap it. Down to six, down to five, four, three, down to two. And they're just going to wait. That'll be the end of the quarter. We will go to quarter number four. It's 27-20 with Kane driving here as we go to quarter number four. We'll take the time out. Don't go away. Got a great finish coming up to this one. You're watching the Kerle Tire High School Football Game of the Week on Explore Clarion at D9Sports.com.
Whether it's your ATV, your camper,
plenty of room, keep it coming,
your boat,
keep dumping water, me boy,
or whatever your big kid toy may be, make sure you protect it. Carrier Insurance Agency will help establish a policy to protect your ATV, camper, boat, motorcycle, or any auto insurance coverage you may need. Receive your free quote at Carrier Insurance Agency in front of Tractor Supply in Clarion or carrierinsurancecares.com.
Locally owned and operated, Hager Paving of Strattonville provides a range of services. Hot mix asphalt, cold patch asphalt, tar and chipping, and seal coating. Hager Paving's reputation in business is based on customer service, referrals, and your satisfaction. Serving residential, commercial, industrial, and local municipalities throughout western Pennsylvania, exceptional service, exceptional quality. That's Hager Paving of Strattonville. Call 814-764-5080. That's 814-764-5080 for Hager Paving.
You're locked on to the EYT Media Network.
Here we go. Kane will start quarter number four as they're knocking on the door. It's a Clarion County Community Bank. Fourth quarter here on the EYT Media Network. Mike Kalinowski, the governor, Bob Dunkel, Dustin Kiefer, Tyler Oakes all here.
You know, on one hand, it's a little easier now as an offensive coordinator because, you know, it's four down territory. You don't got to think about it. You're going to be out there. There's no gray area in this one. You trail by seven. Quarter number four.
Zampona's going to keep the football. Zampona with a stiff arm, and he'll going to be dropped inside the 20-yard line to about the 18.
Zampona on the carry, tackled by
it's gained about a yard and a half, almost two. It sets up a third down. Third down here and five.
And 12 attempts for 17 yards. Tough sledding.
B.
Four down territory here for the Kane Wolves. See if he goes to plants here on third down.
I think you got to chisel away at this, Mike. And again, not take a chance. They elect instead to pass.
Zampona the throw. He's got a man in the end zone. And Simcoe's going to pick it off, though, instead. The ball hung up just too long that time for the receiver to get over to get to it. And Simcoe is there to take it away. Here's the replay on that. You can watch. The ball just hangs up long enough. Simcoe able to react. And the interception.
Well, you can tell, you know, that's the case of Zampona knows where he's got to get the football. But he's more of a running back, obviously. And he's pressed into duty. Nice job. I, again, sort of thought they'd chisel away, Mike. And, you know, trying to obviously keep it on the ground, move the sticks that way. They like to go through the air. And Clarion coming down, Central Clarion coming down with that interception.
Here's the handoff to Rex, who came from that left side on that sweep. He's out across the 30 and out of bounds. He'll have the first down. Gain 10 yards. They're going to move the chains.
Actually, you know, they are taking their time and they're saying, yes, move the chains now.
Look, I called it. Just move it.
Well, you know. By the way, I do got a update my stat sheet a little bit. I had said earlier at halftime, Bracken Rex actually had, unfortunately, 40 more yards on the stat sheet than what he should have. It should have went to Ashton Rex, who had that punt, fake punt run.
Kane shows blitz here and getting the carry that time.
Nice cutback by Hummel.
And Hummel got the carry, so he'll get about 3 yards out to the 33-yard line. Second down here in seven.
You want the five-minute offense to take place here, partner. You do want to score because you're not comfortable with that seven-point lead, but you want to milk as much time as possible. This is where you'd love it. It's unfortunate that you can't see the play clock.
So second down and seven here for the Wildcats from their own 33. They send Hummel in motion. They're going to hand that to Beckwith, and he's going to be cut down immediately at the line of scrimmage. No gain.
You know, this Kane defense, Mike, these guys really like to stuff the hole. They plug the gaps very well. If you're a run tackle to tackle on them, you're going to really earn your yardage.
So a big third down here for the Wildcats. Third down here and still seven as the ball rests just shy of the 33-yard line. Clarion. The Wildcats, the Central Clarion Wildcats, are on their own side of the football field. Just under 10 minutes to go here in the game. They lead by seven. Ashton Rex went in motion. Ball snap back to Ferguson. Flag on the play. Ball dumped downfield. It is caught by Hummel. First down, breaks a tackle midfield. Still on his feet and dropped down near the 46-yard line.
And I think this one's going to come back. Might be a procedure call.
Yeah,
but
looked like the official's
like
given that.
Looked like a shift. It was close, and based on Kane's reaction, probably it is that shift.
Illegal shift against the Wildcats will bring that first down play back.
So that one comes back. It was a nice one, too. Hummel made some great moves.
And, you know, the unfortunate thing is, and of course, obviously has to come back regardless, but the shift really didn't do anything to set the play up. But you still have to call it because they will march him back. Well, optimist Mike Kalinowski says this just gives the offense more room to work with.
That'll push him back to the 28-yard line. Third down and 12. The clock continues to move. 9:37 as it goes away. Kane trying to come up with a big play here. Central Clarion trying to pick up this big first down. Here's on the right side, going for Simcoe. Fight for it. Simcoe pulls it down. Here's Simcoe trying to get out of the tackle. It is a shoestring. He breaks free. 25-20, 15-10-5. Touchdown. 72 yards. And here we go. Let's look at that one again. Look at this. He just kept going and going and going. I don't know if he just took his shoe off and went going, but
I got a still line from Dave Constantino. He did the hokey pokey. I can't take credit for that one, but that's Dave's call all the way. But that's about all you can say to sum that one up. Talk about staying with a play and not giving up on it as an offensive player. Wow. That's
point.
Like second, third, fourth, fifth, eighth effort on that one as that hokey pokey comes through.
Here's Franchino with the extra point try. Kicks on the way, and the kick is up, and that kick by Franchino is good.
And
it is now Clarion, Central Clarion 34, and Kane 20. We'll take a break. 9:16 to go in this one. Central Clarion up on Kane. You're listening and watching Carly Tire High School football on Explore Clarion and D9Sports.com.
Red Bank Clarion Chevrolet, the area's number one Chevrolet dealer and Clarion County's truck headquarters. So if you're in the market for a new or used Chevrolet car, truck, or SUV, go to Red Bank Chevrolet, 500 Broad Street in New Bethlehem, or online redbankchevrolet.com. Skilled staff at Red Bank Chevrolet is ready to meet all of your automotive needs. If we don't see you today, we'll see you at Red Bank Chevrolet.
One of the biggest risks to your future could be running out of money during a longer-than-expected retirement. Many people have not yet taken the time to determine if they will have enough assets to last throughout retirement. Our Retirement Income Evaluator can help you develop a roadmap and actionable recommendations. To learn more, stop by our office located at 162 South 2nd Avenue in Clarion. Give us a call at 2223-9990 or visit JennyClarion.com. Jenny Montgomery Scott, LLC, member NYSE, FINRA, and SIPC.
This is the EYT Media Network.
Central Clarion on the board. The big 72-yard pass play from Ferguson to Simcoe. Here's the kickoff. It's going to be taken back at the 10 up to the 15 near the 20-yard line. 25 and right around the 30. That's where Kane will have the football. 9:10 to go here in this one. See what the flag is here on the play. And penalties again brought to you by Red Bank Chevrolet.
Yep, personal foul will go against the Wildcats.
Against Central Clarion. Should give the Wolves great starting position.
Mike, more scoring updates. St. Mary's takes the lead against Carnes City, 27-21.
Wow.
At the 8:32 mark. That's a big one. I think that's going to catch a lot of people off guard. Brookville 26, Montauk 0, Red Bank Valley up 27-6 over Smethport in quarter number 4. County up 44-18 over Bucktail. Mike Ridgeway pulling away from your Chucks, 33-13. Very late in quarter number 4 in that ball game.
Zampona remains quarterback here for Kane. Morris went down with the injury a bit earlier there in the third quarter. Zampona lost the football, picks it back up, though. He's under a lot of pressure. He's going to be hit, driven backwards, and he's hit by Rex and finally dropped. They're going to give him forward progress, and that forward progress will be at about the 39-yard line. So that's going to be a loss of 6 yards on the play.
And yeah, just a tough, tough play on that one for Zampona.
So second down.
You know, this is where, you know, now you got to score twice, so you got to take some chances. You hate to abandon the running game when you're a run-oriented team, and, of course, adding to the challenge is Harley Morris is not out there as your gunslinger.
Second and 16 here for the Wolves. Zampona keeps it rushing right up the middle of the field. 50, first down and more, busted. 35-30, down to the 25-yard line.
Just like that, what a burst of speed. You see why he was leading the team in rushing coming into this ball game. You can see why with a run like that. Gets 36 yards on that one.
That'll be a first down at the 25.
So into Clarion territory, big time here for Kane. They're not giving up yet. Clock turning down to 7:54. Central Clarion up 34-20. But Kane now driving into Central Clarion territory. Here's the handoff. That is Plants, and Plants, boy, they were tugging his shirt and everything, but he leans forward, and he'll get a couple yards down to the 23-yard line.
Brought down by Ian Hagan.
So 2 yards, second down and 8.
When you tackle Plants, you certainly know it. He makes you pay the price.
About second and 8.
Good hard-nosed runner. Taking a lot of time off the clock. Remember, they've got to score twice. There is a decent amount of time yet, 7:15 here in quarter number 4. They trail by 14.
Zampona going to give that to Plants over the right side. Plants spinning around inside the 20, down to the 19-yard line. Give Plants 4. And it sets up a third down here and still about 4 for Kane.
Just under 7 minutes.
I'd keep this ball on the ground. There's not a chance I'd go to the air. Have confidence in your backs and your offensive line, but it's going to be a lot harder now as a false start takes place.
Yep, movement on that right side of the line is going to bring it back. Stops the clock at 6:40.
Yeah, what happens there when you're in a lineman, you're in a position that long, sometimes you will just lose your balance. And one of the most famous residents in Clarion County.
Gus Simpson. Didn't put him in the game yet tonight, but still some time.
Well, he's used up all of his eligibility, I believe. I believe.
Except in a couple of the divisions out west. Zampona takes the snap, hands that ball to Plants, and Plants goes right up the middle, and he'll be stopped at the 20-yard line. Give him...
Looks like he picked up about half of what he needed for the first down.
They've moved him back with the penalty, so it's still about It's a long five. It's just ball's, shy of the 20.
Yep, ball's just about at that 20 exactly.
6 minutes to go exactly. Fourth down, five for Kane. This could be their ball game right here. Big play. Zampona keeps it over the right side. Zampona weaving around, leans forward, and he's going to be short of the first down marker. He's not going to get there. So Central Clarion will take over on downs as he's about a yard shy. He picks up about four, but that's it. And Central Clarion will take over, and now you'll probably see a nice steady diet of run, and run a little bit more.
Yeah, you don't want to make a mistake, obviously, in this situation. That yardage, by the way, short by roughly about a half a yard.
Yep.
As the final spot is down on the ground. And now you can see Kane is going to shoot the gaps. They're going to take chances. They're going to try and force a turnover here or at least a quick punt.
Ferguson ready under center. Sends the man in motion. Pitches that ball to Rex. That's Brecken Rex over the right side. Banging around, and Rex will take it up to the 20-yard line. That's a gain of four. Second down here and six. See if Kane decides to use any timeouts here with 5:28. They trail by the two scores. They need something to happen quickly here. And for Central Clarion, it's just control the ball, let the clock run. They look to pick up win number one of the season. They were 0-4 coming in. 3-2 was Kane. Simcoe sets up left side as he went. He's going to go out wide, but then comes in closer to the line of scrimmage. They're tight at that line. Ferguson waiting for that back judge to give him the signal with 5 seconds. The play clocks are not working here at Memorial Stadium. Ball snap, Ferguson hands the football, and that's Rex with it. Brecken Rex breaks it, 30, 35, 40, and hits a first down as it is out at the 44-yard line.
Pick up a first down.
So Central Clarion will move the chains here out to the 44-yard line.
We've got a final, Red Bank 27, Smith.
And the clock will continue to move. So from the 44, Central Clarion keeps their drive alive. They've got the two-score lead on Kane. Ferguson checks with the sidelines, now comes in, makes sure everybody's on the same page. Beckwith will go. Actually, Ferguson comes up under center. Now they got to hurry. They're going to hand that ball to Hummel. Hummel over the left side, and Hummel's going to get dropped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. Second down and 10, down to 3:58 now at this point.
Ridgeway 33, Punxsutawney 13.
You see that clock just continue to move and move and move.
Phillipsburg, Osceola 49.
Second down and a long 10, the ball just behind the 44-yard line.
Be second and 11 for the Wildcats.
Smith will come over to the right side along with Simcoe, but they're all tight there at that line of scrimmage. You see a lot of run. It's like, second down.
You know, again, you know that Kane is going to try and plug these gaps, force a turnover. They're going to be ball hawks this situation. They got to come up with two big plays.
Ferguson under center. Man went in motion. They're going to hand that off, and nothing doing that time. Not at all. As Clarion's going to be dropped for the loss, that's Ashton Rex on the carry. They're going to say forward progress was stopped at the 39-yard line. And that'll be a loss of almost five on the play. And Kane will use a timeout here with 3:07 to go, 34-20 the score. And why don't we break as well? It's 34-20, Central Clarion up on Kane. You're watching Carly Tire High School Football and Explore Clarion, D9Sports.com.
Locally owned and operated.
Our community needs its local businesses. Let's put unity back into the community. Let's all unite to support local business. Butler Health System, proudly standing with our local businesses. Your choice matters. When the time comes, choose local. Let's all unite to support them and the other local businesses in your community. It's important because when local businesses thrive, communities thrive.
Red Bank Chevrolet, the area's number one Chevrolet dealer and Clarion County's truck headquarters. So if you're in the market for a new or used Chevrolet car, truck, or SUV, go to Red Bank Chevrolet, 500 Broad Street in New Bethlehem, or online redbankchevrolet.com. Skilled staff at Red Bank Chevrolet is ready to meet all of your automotive needs. If we don't see you today, we'll see you at Red Bank Chevrolet.
The EYT Media Network.
All right, here we go. Central Clarion with the football. Third down and 15 is what they face. 34-20, Central Clarion leads Kane here. Kane used the timeout. If they don't get it here, you might see Kane use another, but Kane jumps. Or it's up, I think, the left side of that offensive line moved. This may back Clarion up. Kane was off, but then we had one of the Clarion linemen upset. Yep.
Officials indicate it is.
There it is.
Procedure call.
So the 15 goes to a third and 20.
An opportunity here on third down to convert, but play smart with this football. Don't take a chance. Don't chuck the rock short. If you're going to throw a little on the deeper side, but they do keep it on the ground, which is a wise move.
And that was Rex. Brecken Rex got the carry. He picks up about a yard is all. Go football on the EYT Media Network.
Jan here. Making it safer to save today. As we all adjust to the new normal, shopping for furniture is a little different. That's why our team wears masks and goes the extra mile while delivering in your home. It's why our website is so informative, enabling you to buy online or by phone. That's why we limit shoppers and offer special hours for our at-risk neighbors, first responders, and healthcare professionals. Your waiting is over. Let us help you save safely today.
This is the EYT Media Network.
All right, we go right back to action. It is fourth down. Central Clarion will punt here. Rex the punt. And the ball's going to bounce around, and it's going to get away and behind Ackley. And at the 22-yard line, that's where Kane will have it with 2:52 to go. They trail by the two scores. They need a quick strike. See what happens here if they're going to go to the air. I think it's a question of if.
You know, you don't really necessarily want to play a prevent defense or a soft defense. I think you play them straight up. You've done a good job of it so far tonight, but one thing you want to remember is there's not a problem as long as you keep that defender in front of you. It's just that the defender gets by you.
Zampona working in the shotgun here for Kane. Going to fire the ball over the right side, and the pass is incomplete. And trying to get that over to Dar that time, and it's incomplete.
You know, we talk all the time, too. You know, now's... If you're the offensive coordinator, look, you know, you got four downs to get the 10 yards. You obviously want to get it a whole lot quicker than that, but you can take some chances here.
Zampona ready. He's got Plant's sidecar left. Always see a draw to him, too. He can make some things happen. Nope, Zampona's going to keep the football. Spins around the middle of the field. Stays on his feet. Out across the 30. Powell moves to the 35-yard line. And how about that? He's going to gain yardage out to the 36-yard line. That's a gain of 16 on the play. They're going to move the chains.
Yeah, tough as nails. You see some nice spin moves. You see why he is a top-notch running back, Mike.
Zampona takes the snap, looks to throw this time, looks to the left side. Fires downfield. He's got a man coming back. It's caught. And inside the 30, down to about the 27-yard line, coming up with a catch. That was Szymanski. So Szymanski brings it down into Clarion territory. They're going to put it all the way down to the 26-yard line.
Temporarily stop the clock.
So 2:21, Kane. We said they need a quick strike. They're moving the ball right down the field.
And really, you got to be pleased if you're on that Kane coaching staff.
Zampona to the right side, and it's incomplete. Lundeen was the...
But you got to score quickly.
Stops the clock.
How about Szymanski on the night, Mike? 43 yards. Big clutch reception that last play.
Second and 10 for Zampona from the 26. Across the middle, he's got a man. It's caught inside the 5. It's a first and goal. And Lundin is the one on the end of that one all the way down to the 5-yard line. That's a gain of 21. And Kane's in business, still 2 minutes to go. Zampona from the 5, keeps the football, follows his blocker. He's in the end zone, touchdown. Oh, my. Minute 52, Mark. Zampona in the end zone. So we still got a ball game here.
Yeah, nice, fantastic job there at the 152 mark. He punches it in.
They're going to go for 2. Zampona takes the snap, and he's going to be brought down shy of that goal line. So 34 to 26 is where we stand on the two after the two-point conversion. Why don't we take time on? And you're watching Carly Tire High School Football. It's live on Explore Clarion and D9Sports.com.
J&J Trailers and Equipment Sales on Route 66 in Shippenville is your one-stop trailer shop for all things trailers. J&J stocks over 70 trailers at a time of all shapes and sizes, including enclosed cargoes, equipment haulers, utility trailers, tilt trailers, and dump trailers. Reputable brands include CarMate, Sport Haven, PJ, Liberty, and Wells Cargo. If you are looking for the most dependable trailers on the market, backed by the industry's best warranty, choose J&J Trailers and Equipment Sales. Trailers that work for a living.
This is the EYT Media Network.
Right back here at Clarion University's Memorial Stadium. Mike Kalinowski, the Governor Bob Dunkel, Dustin Kiefer, Tyler Oaks, we're all here tonight. Got a good one, 34-26 now the score. Kane scores. Now we're going to watch for that onside kick. Out there on the kick is Bakakis.
Yeah, this isn't a bad idea of the Wildcats electing to keep one guy deep, because if they pooch it, you're in trouble.
There it
is.
That's
what they do.
Yep. It's going to bounce, and is it going to go out of bounds? It does.
The kickoff inside.
Or does he get it before?
I think he touches it before.
Okay, so he did touch it before, so that's where Central Clarion will have it.
But, you know, that's a good safe play, because what if that ball stops?
Oh, absolutely. That's a live ball. We've seen that several times.
And it happened this season on us. Yeah, Red Bank Valley took a big advantage of it in the game we had early on. Seems like a decade ago we did that game, but, you know.
Seems like a decade ago, too, we were young.
Well, it's more than one decade since we were young.
Ball sitting at the 19-yard line here for Central Clarion. Minute 52. Ferguson hands that off to Breck, and Rex tries to turn over the right side. Here's Rex, and he's going to be brought down. He'll get good yardage out across the 25-yard line.
And that should be the final timeout taken by Kane.
He's going to pick up 6 on the carry, second down and 4. We'll just keep it here. So a minute 43 to go in this one. Central Clarion leads 34-26. Central Clarion faces a second and 4. So we'll see what they can do here as Kane using their last timeout.
And really, as if you're Central Clarion, the discussion is just hold on to the ball, stay in bounds, try and pick up the first down. You remember, stay in bounds. And now if you're Kane, strip the ball. Go after it. Take chances.
Well, they still have a minute 43. It's a second down. Central Clarion, after this, you know they're going to keep it on the ground here, and then the clock's going to run. And Kane jumps. That'll give Central Clarion the first down.
And that's part of that, you know, taking chances, and it's just the byproduct of it. That will move the sticks.
So they'll move the chains, and now Central Clarion is just a matter of a couple of knees, and they'll get out of this one with their first victory of the season. They'll go to 1-4. Kane will drop to 3-3 overall.
And bringing it in tight for that victory formation. Double insurance. You keep one back 10 yards behind the line.
And Ferguson will take the knee, and now it's academic from here as Central Clarion will come up with their first win. Of course, we got our post-game show on the way. We'll have more coming up for you. We'll have stats, the final stats, brought to you by Laurel Eye Clinic, our Hager Paving player of the game. Ty Nesta Builder, something to build on today, certainly for Clarion area, was this victory. You know, getting that first one in the books for Kane, getting that late touchdown, not giving up.
Mike, I think if you take a look back in this ball game, as you review the tape, one of the things you have to be excited about, whether your teammate, your coach, whatever your role is on the team, it was a total team effort because the offense made plays when it had to. Defense made some big plays. Special teams made big plays. Rarely do you get everybody all on the same page to contribute like that. And then again, it took a total team effort. That's why they were able to come away with the win. They knew coming in they had to limit mistakes, take advantage of opportunities given to them, and they did that.
Down to 40 seconds. This will be the last kneel. As the clock works its way to expiration. Ferguson takes his final knee. The players will start to shake hands down there. And Central Clarion will get win number one of the season. They're celebrating here at Memorial Stadium. And we'll take a timeout. We're going to come back. Bob will add some things up, and we'll be set for you for our first United National Bank postgame show. Central Clarion a winner here tonight, 34-26 over Kane. And you're watching Carly Tire High School Football's Game of the Week. It's here on Explore Clarion and D9Sports.com.
He's on the 30. He's on the 20. He's on the 10. It's a touchdown.
There's nothing like football. The lights, the cheers of the crowd, and getting a chance to see our local athletes and kids give it all they've got. Come to a game. Support our local schools.
Clarion County Community Bank. A better way to bank. Member FDIC. Visit us online at clarionbank.com.
Zockrell Motor Truck Sales in Clarion is an International Diamond Edge Certified Service Department. As one of only 276 such shops in all of North America, you can be sure that when your medium or heavy-duty truck needs service, the job will be done correctly at Zockrell Motors. Our work is guaranteed nationwide at any international truck dealer, and our parts and service prices can't be beaten. Our technicians are factory trained and factory certified. Don't trust a shop that just thinks that they can make repairs. Come to Zockrell Motors Diamond Edge Certified Service Department. If it's maintenance you need, click ZockrellMotors.com or call us for a quote on those jobs too. Our prices are great. Best of all, you know the repair is done right and it's guaranteed. Get your truck service work done at Zockrell Motor Truck Sales, 2 miles north of exit 64 Interstate 80 in Clarion.
Listening to the EYT Media Network.
All right, here we go. Final score, 34-26. Central Clarion knocking off Kane. We're in the first United National Bank postgame show. Time for those stats sponsored by the Laurel Eye Clinic.
Well, as we take a look at Kane, Mike, it came a long ways in the second half. You know, at halftime, only had 164 yards, finished with 371 on the night. 208 on the ground, 163 through the air. We came in realizing that you know, they needed to basically run 2-to-1 ratio over passing, and that didn't happen in the ball game. That proved to be the difference. But 208 on the ground, leading the way. It was Ricky Zampona with 73 yards, one rushing touchdown. Addison Plants, really a big night for him too. Now only 46 yards, but they were punishing yards. Did have two touchdowns in the ball game as well. 77 yards. Actually, you know, I said Ricky Zampona led the way with 73. He did not. 77 yards out of Harley Morris. Harley Morris led the way there with 73 yards and 6 yards each out of Reese Bachakis and Shane Ackley. From the passing attack, Harley Morris would finish 7 of 18 with two interceptions and one touchdown to go along with that. Ricky Zampona checks in at 2 of 5, 62 yards, and one interception as well. Hauling in receptions, Landon Darr checks in with 39, 81 yards out of Sam Lundin, and Szymanski checks in with 43 yards. Again, 371 yards of total offense. For Central Clarion, it was 371 on this one, and relatively balanced ball game for them as well. They finished 151 on the ground. In no particular order, Jace Ferguson checks in with 4 yards in this one and one rushing touchdown. 73 yards out of Breck and Rex. Now, earlier on at halftime, I had him at 40. We had to adjust that because the long run on the fake punt was done by Ashton Rex. So that's why if you listen to the halftime, you come back, you're like, well, how did that happen? He didn't get sacked for 40 yards. So we had to make a correction on that. But Ashton Rex, by the way, finishes with 35 yards, 29 yards out of Ryan Hummel, and Braylon Beckwith checks in with 10 yards. Jace Ferguson, good night for him. He finishes 8 of 17, 3 touchdowns, 1 interception. As we look at receiving, big night for Christian Simcoe, who was able to do the hokey pokey on one of the touchdowns. He has 167 yards, 42 yards out of Ashton Rex. Ryan Hummel checks in with 6 and Brecken Rex with 5. By the way, got to credit our good friend, Hall of Famer Dave Constantino with the hokey pokey phrase. So I can't steal that one, won't try to, but you know, fantastic effort out of these Central Clarion Wildcats tonight, Mike. 371 yards on the night.
Again, that's stats brought to you by the Laurel Eye Clinic. Our winging it pass of the game brought to you by Sweet Basil Italian Restaurant. And we'll go back to Simcoe, pass from Ferguson. It went 72 yards. Simcoe had to shake off the guy where you were saying, you know, he was talking about the hokey pokey. So that'll be
the only way to describe it. I mean,
absolutely.
Good job by Dave.
Yep. So that's our winging it of the game. And, Bob, now time for the Hager Paving Player of the Ball Game. Who do you like?
Well, a little bit of a debate here. We're actually going to give this to Christian Simcoe. Any guy who can do the hokey pokey, get a 72-yard touchdown, he's going to be the Hager Paving Player that night. He finishes with two touchdowns on the night, 167 yards. Jace Ferguson in close consideration, but we like to give it to Christian Simcoe. Again, outstanding effort out of not just Simcoe, but really this entire team. Total team effort tonight. They come away a big winner here.
All right, that's going to wrap up the First United National Bank, the Fun Bank postgame show. Next week, we're going to be on the air a couple nights for you. We'll have volleyball early in the week, and then I think we have that AC Valley Clarion volleyball match coming up on Tuesday. And then coming up on Thursday, it will be at Keystone High School, Keystone Union AC Valley, and that Autumn Leaf Festival special. Friday night, we'll be at Red Bank Valley for Bucktail and Red Bank Valley. It's all coming up this week. More great sports on the way, and Central Clarion a winner here tonight.
I want to thank the many guys helping the broadcast tonight. Tyler Oakes, our usual steady cameraman. Dustin Kiefer, our producer, was cracking the whip on you all night, partner.
Yep.
Got to thank you, Mike Kalinowski. And, of course, this is Governor Bob Dunkel saying, hey, let's be careful out there.